Everybody, welcome to the A&N After Show. It's me, Lynzee Loveridge. This is a special trailer watch party version, and I think I got us on Instagram. So if you are tuning in now, I'm jumping between computers in order to make sure that the most of you can watch along with us. So hi again. It's almost New Year's. Hope everyone has had a great holiday. What are your resolutions this year? Let us know in the chat. I think I'm going to pick like a fun resolution this year and just watch maybe more anime. Why make yourself better when you could just consume more media in the never-ending cycle that we call life? Anyway, we're here to help with you picking what you want to watch for the next upcoming season. We're going to be watching all the trailers from the January 2024 anime season. We've got about 45-ish, definitely less than last season. If you were here, we had, I think, over 60 trailers. So I don't know. I guess people decided to kind of rein it in a little bit. So before we get started, I want to remind our viewers that if you enjoy this stream, Anime News Network is also home of the A&N After Show, which is what I said we were doing at the top of this. It's a weekly live podcast recording right here on Tuesdays at 6 p.m. Pacific, 9 p.m. Eastern. We also have new videos up almost daily, including new snippets that you can use to stay on top of what's going on in the anime world. So you want to follow us here on Facebook. We're streaming there right now. Twitter/X, where we are streaming right now. Instagram, which we'll be streaming to for about an hour because they currently have like a limitation on how long we can stream. So if you're here on Instagram, I'm going to put a ticker up in a little bit so you can continue watching over here on YouTube or any of those other social medias I mentioned. We also have TikTok. We're not streaming there right now, but who knows? We use StreamYard, so that could happen anytime. They just have to add some functionality there. So yes, if this is your first time watching a trailer watch party and you are watching us on Instagram, again, this will only be here for about an hour. Let me put that ticker up for you guys. It is right here. Instagram. You see right there? Stream the whole thing, youtube.com/anime news network. So that's where we are at. If you want to continue watching along with us. Without further ado, though, I'd like to welcome my marathon compatriots back for the winter 2024 edition of the Anime Trailer Watch Party. Jacki Jing, James Beckett, and Geoff Thew from Mother's Basement. Hi, everybody.
Hey.
Hi. James, you're muted before we get too far into this.
That's what I gotta get used to with this new mic.
We all got mics for Christmas, I think. Or a lot of us did. I haven't set mine up yet, but James is testing out a new one. Geoff, how are you doing over there?
I'm doing good. We've been having sort of a quiet Christmas after a big crunch on the last big video of the year. Doing good. Excited for the new season.
Enjoying that Christmas to New Year lull.
That little bit of a break where I don't got to do nothing is pretty nice. I've been playing this Japanese SimCity style game called A-Train, which is like, it seems like a cute little train, you know, build a little train, a little low poly Japanese town, watch it grow across the entire history of Japanese transit from the 1950s all the way up to the 2020s, which is very impressive, you know. But under the hood, it's actually like one of the most cavernously deep and evil economic simulations I've ever seen. You can just the actual name of the game, it seems like the game is about, you know, build the train line, connect people, bring tourists to places up. But what you can do is you can buy stocks in companies who are directly affected by your railroad, and also buy like real estate around wherever you're going to build your train station. And then you can also like create like subsidiaries. Like you can own an arcade right next to your train station that's next to like a pachinko parlor that the kids from the arcade go to. You can do, it's just great. It's great. And
Geoff, I didn't know you were a train otaku until now.
I'm not. I'm becoming one because
okay. Say that can change at any time.
Yeah. Yeah. Also, just as a heads up, everybody, I'm getting a thing through StreamYard that maybe Facebook isn't working right now. So if that's true, I'm sorry. I don't know why. So don't know, everyone's favorite platform, right? If you're trying to watch on Facebook, then I guess you're maybe not hearing anything I'm saying right now.
Facebook.com/anime news network?
Yeah.
Let's see.
I don't know if I can, like, remake the video so that it'll work over there. So
I don't see us live over there.
Yeah, how strange. Don't know what happened. It said, you know, maybe the stream was ended or deleted on Facebook, and they'll keep trying and let us know if it's resolved. So, hey, just, you know, now's a great time to head over to Geoff's Twitch streaming, or head over to @anime on @X/Twitter, or head over to Anime News Network on Instagram to watch.
Or YouTube.
Right? YouTube is really probably the best one, assuming, you know, we don't get booted off the air temporarily, because that also happens.
That happens a lot. The more bannable words there are in an anime title, the more likely
it'll be to happen. You can also go to animenewsnetwork.com, our actual website, and there is a article there for this that has both the YouTube embed and the Facebook embed that's not working on it. So actually, that's probably not helpful. Go over to Twitter, or probably Twitter. Twitter is the best one to have as a backup in case anything happens here right now. Or Geoff's Twitch, like we were saying. So if everybody is ready, I have looked through our stream selection. Like I said before, this is probably a shorter trailer watch party, just due to the fact that there's a somewhat manageable amount of anime this season. Didn't see anything that was grabbing me, but I've got my notebook and pen ready to make my top five. So, you know, there could still be some surprises. So make
there's
sure to have
one every watch.
I am very much looking forward to writing down my top four and Dungeon Meshi.
So you've already got that spot. I'll talk about Dungeon Meshi when we get there. I did get to see the first episode of Delicious in Dungeon at AX this year, and then
jealous.
Richard got to see the first three in Japan. So we've already got some takes on that show. But that's the new Studio Trigger show about, you know, trying to save a girl who was swallowed by a dragon before she's fully digested. But in order to do that, they got to eat monsters in the dungeon on the way to, you know, get to the dragon. So it's kind of a cooking show. Anyway, so before we get to Dungeon Meshi, I have a few quick reminders. If you've been here before, this is all going to seem really familiar, but we'll be marathoning all the trailers for the upcoming season. So you're going to want to have a drink and some snacks. I didn't bring snacks this time, but I've got some mysterious liquid.
I got some Fiji flavored Old Spice deodorant. I guess I'll eat that.
Geoff, that's not food. Geoff, that's not food. You can't do
it
that.
Probably tastes like a pina colada. So that's
probably. Now that I'm thinking about it, I have to.
Someone take it from him. So you're gonna want to have those. We already went over the YouTube spiel. So if YouTube goes down, head over to @anime on Twitter to continue watching, or Geoff's Twitch stream.
Twitch.tv/this, but without the space. Oh God!
Mother's basement, one word.
No, it's just slash Geoff Thew.
Oh, Geoff Thew, all one word. Right.
All one word. So maybe without the little space there.
Maybe we'll end up on Facebook eventually, but I don't know, guys. I don't know what's going on there. You know, we always have one tech thing. So we're going to be offering our commentary throughout the stream, and at the end, we'll share our top fives. Without further ado, let me get this ball rolling with our first show. This is Sasaki and Peeps. Unfortunately, quite a lot of these trailers are going to have subtitles this time, but I've got, you know, notes.
I'm not hearing anything.
Oh, you're not hearing the audio. All right. Let's
no audio, but the bird is very, very cute.
It's a very cute horrible bird. All right.
Well, if the boy in the heron taught me anything, it's that birds are inherently evil monsters and we shouldn't trust any of them.
Yeah, pretty much.
Can you hear it?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Here we go. This is Sasaki and Peeps.
Why do I feel like I've seen a trailer for this already?
I don't know. Okay, the bird can talk.
Yeah, I feel like maybe I read about this already or something.
It's a light novel series.
And he's super magic.
The bird can do magic, okay. So it's an isekai, but I think he goes back and forth, maybe? I think the animation looks nice.
Yeah, it's very calming and pretty.
One of those isekai things, huh?
Yeah.
I kind of like that the main character looks like he's at least 40. You know, we don't get that a lot.
No.
He has the power to shoot Adobe After Effects in his enemies.
I kind of like the chef guy. He's cute.
Yeah, the characters are cute.
Yeah.
Oh, like, it could be really funny, too.
The character designs look kind of familiar, and I can't quite place where
I mean, those girls kind of look like magical girl show protagonists or something.
Well, yeah.
I mean, so that one is a magical girl. But
oh,
like,
you know what? You know what it is, Geoff? They kind of look similar character designs as ReZero.
Oh, yeah. You're...
I can see that, yeah.
Yeah. Something like that.
So that's Sasaki and Peeps. Let's see if I can put my coffee somewhere where I don't continue to bump my mic. That one looked pretty cute. As far as, again, like, expect a lot of isekai, reverse isekai, villainess isekai this season. There's quite a lot of it. So we didn't really have nearly as much. So it's last season. So it kind of feels like they're making up time.
I feel like they do that. I feel like every other season they kind of dump all of the isekai and the villainess and the reincarnation anime all at once.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean there were quite a few. They were just like more interesting last season, like Tear Moon Empire doesn't feel like a reincarnation story, but like fundamentally it's the same, a similar idea. You know?
Yeah.
Like
she just gets to have character development, which is, you know, always fun.
The bird is cute. I need to see more, though. I didn't really, like, nothing sold me on it.
Yeah, like, I mean, like, the battle animation looked all right, you know. But
yeah.
I need the bird to be cuter.
Yes, you need the bird to be cute. I thought the bird was pretty cute as far as a sparrow.
It wasn't doing it for me.
Bird, I like the bird.
Would you like it more if it was, like, a cockatiel?
No, just, like, I don't know. Like, his personality just seemed like... He seemed like a... Like a cute bird version of like the omniscient video game narration voice that you get in these isekai anime.
Oh,
or like
okay.
The little AI, like the AI partner or whatever, right?
Yeah.
I didn't see like a whole lot of personality other than is bird and talks, but
yeah.
maybe that'll be in the show.
Yeah. For those who are interested in Sasaki and Peeps, that one will be streaming on Crunchyroll. So for our next one, this is Dr. Elise, the royal lady with the lamp. So that's
with the lamp. Okay.
That is full screen. Right. I don't know why it looks like that. Okay. She was mean in her first life. And then was reborn in the current world and became a doctor. And this plane is going to crash, guys.
She's getting reborn again.
That's the final destination plane.
Oh no, so now she's going to be reborn again? But as her previous
life, she has a second chance.
It's a third chance at this point.
No, it's her.
I mean,
third chance.
Character
now she's a doctor, and she's going to be nice this time.
She's Dr. Princess.
I will save someone.
I wanted to have one job and then I died and got isekai and I'm gonna keep trying to have that one job thing. Like
bookworm.
I love bookworm.
Yeah.
The guy who just wants to make pastries, he's alright. I enjoyed some episodes of that, but like I don't know.
That was cute.
I guess I want us to get to the point in the oversaturation of the genre where we have, like, we just get to the anthology series where, like, every episode is directed by a completely, like, different person with a completely different style. And it's just a guy getting
isekai'd
over and over and over and over again.
That's
someone give James money. I'd watch that.
Yeah, I would. Yeah, the same guy watch. Just can't get.
He's the kind into multiple worlds, a different world every episode.
That's kind of the premise of a Benobashi.
Magical shopping arcade.
Benobashi. It's
maybe I accidentally plagiarized. Yeah.
That one's more out there. It's about like this shopping arcade that was built on old Onmyoji mystical grounds that has like connections to a bunch of other worlds, and like it's just nuts. It's the only anime I've ever seen with a Monty Python reference.
Oh my gosh, I love that.
Yeah. But if at all, it's you know that clip that goes around Twitter every couple of years or so of the guy with the hot dog cart? He's like, "Hey kid, you want some fucking hot dogs? I'm fucking American. Love America. Hot dogs. Babes. Get your babes and fucking hot dogs."
I've never seen this, but no. I want to now.
It's so, yeah.
That's
so
from...
Benobashi. Yeah, I think you should leave. It's one of the most underrated, in my opinion, Gainax shows.
I know. Yeah, I know. It's a late Gainax. Was Imaishi still on? That sounds like Imaishi humor.
It was pre Gurren, so it was like between. You know, it was in the era between like Eva and Gurren, where they were like trying other stuff. I think.
Recently recommended the first episode of Gurren to my 14-year-old, and he watched it. So.
And thought what?
I have to ask him.
Oh my god, I love that anime. In the last anime's defense, I got major Sailor Moon vibes. I don't know why.
The guys are all really cute.
The guy reminded me so much of Mamoru, and yeah. I definitely got like kind of Serena vibes from her, and like the world with the flowers, and they were like in that garden. I was just like, aesthetic wise, that really spoke to me. But I'm not a big fan of we're going to see a ton of isekai, so I don't want to say entirely.
But, by the way, for anyone in the chat that's wondering, unfortunately, at least in North America, Magical Shopping Arcade of Benobashi does not seem to be streaming anywhere.
Yeah, no, you got to get it on DVD.
It's probably eBay.
Oh, that's an eBay hunt. Yeah.
Yeah.
I got two copies of it, like one of the like old thin packs, and then got really lucky the second to last time I was at AX. They had these. Do you know the tin boxes that Gainax used to put out?
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah, I got one of those for it. They're a little hard to find. On the subject of that last isekai, though, just while we've got a bunch of internet savvy people watching, I think it would be really funny to see stuff from that trailer with just the girl saying that, "I am a surgeon! I am a surgeon!" That bit from The Good Doctor over and over again, that would be really funny.
I have never watched it.
It's one of the best out of context clips you'll ever watch. I promise.
We've got lots of people in the chat too that are talking. James, they're saying that your pitch is Quantum Leap or Sliders as well. I've seen.
I'm also talking kind of like
it's got a die at the end
style. Where like every episode just feels like a completely different thing.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
Like one of them feels like a trigger anime. One of them feels like a Kyo Annie anime. One of them feels like
Space Dandy is kind of that.
But he dies every episode. That's the catharsis I want.
Yeah. Yeah. All right. So our third one, this manga is actually really popular with over in Japan. And you can read it on, I think, Manga Plus, the Manga Plus app, possibly also the Viz Manga app. I'm not sure about that second one, but it's definitely on Manga Plus. If you read the description for it, it doesn't really tell you much of anything. And since I haven't read the manga, I don't really have a good description for what's going on in this trailer either. But the name of the show is 'Tis Time for Torture, Princess. And I know it's a comedy, so that's about all I can give you on this. That's the princess. I think the torture is a lot like that anime from a season or so ago called
The
Naughtiness One, where it was just about eating sweets and stuff.
So more like 'tis time for caloric temptation.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure the word torture is in parentheses in the title.
Time jam makes good stuff.
Yeah, that's a pretty cool looking demon, not gonna lie.
That's one of the better Demon King designs I've seen in long time.
I'm loving the color palette.
Oh, I love her.
Well, I like the guy behind her, though.
That,
Oh, they're cute. Yeah.
Playing video games.
Playing video games in the spell. Oh, I like her.
Yeah, there's
a mirror.
This seems like it is on the higher end of the goofy sitcom spectrum.
Yeah. Doodles like the Great from Twitch says this is like Sleepy Princess, but she's hungry instead of tired.
Oh, that's
relatable.
Cute. Yeah.
I relate to that.
Aww.
I'm trying to tell how weird it's going to get with the fan service.
I don't know. It seems like a lot of maybe like food.
It's making me very hungry. That's all I can
say. Yeah, I'm also really hungry. Like, oh, God, I want karage. Oh, gosh, I want
sake. Pine Jam usually doesn't go too hard with fan service, though. Like,
yeah.
The last thing they did that I watched was
the one about plays. The girls at the place, the school for Takarazuka.
Is that the one that I bounced off like really hard because of my super nitpicky theater kid?
Possibly, James. It's really
I'm a theater kid and I love that one. It's great.
Yeah. Go back and try it.
I just I had fundamental issues with the
Kageki Shoujo. Thanks, everyone. Yeah.
Yeah. But
trying to depict the subtle Shoujo reviews
don't like.
Oh. Well, I liked it.
Quite a lot.
But it was 100% a me thing. That was when I was this show seems perfectly fine, but
it's other people are suggesting Starlight Review. Was it possibly Starlight Review, James?
No. It's not Kageki Shoujo Review Starlight. Ooh. Two different series, which is very confusing.
I have good taste. I like every Starlight.
Both are very good series that theater kids would enjoy. But Kageki Shoujo is more of like a girl trashy drama, I would say. Like good kind of girl trash.
Yeah. I mean, they deal with some serious issues like eating disorders and things like that in it. It's very sincere.
It's sincere, but it's also got like, you know, a little bit of like mean girl stuff to it.
Yeah. And there's a little bit like Yuri sprinkling on the top too, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
World Die Star. That's what I'm thinking of.
Oh, you're thinking of World Die Star, not Kageki.
Oh, no, that one sucked. World Die Star.
Okay.
Okay.
James has been avenged.
Yeah, no. Kageki Shoujo. It's also like that one wasn't regular Kageki Shoujo, not Review Starlight. That one wasn't Yuri, right? But
it wasn't blatant, but I mean
it wasn't blatant.
Like the main two girls are very shippable.
Okay, I'm trying to remember because like Review Starlight is like super
girl with the pigtails and she's very tall, and then she has like the kind of ice queen roommate with like the blue kind of bobbed hair.
I remember this now. Okay.
Yeah.
But, I remember this because you told me it had a tall girl in it, and I think that's why you sent it to
me.
Yeah,
I did.
Here's another tall girl.
Yeah,
she's very tall. Yeah.
And it's also interesting because they're like putting on the Rose of Versailles play.
The actual one that's very famous
in real Takarazuka reviews, the Lady Oscar, which is that's really cool. Like that adds like another level if you're a fan of
Sounds interesting to you guys. We got to interview the director for Kageki Shoujo over on Anime News Network when the series was airing, so you can also go read about it over there. Just gonna plug that. I think I did that interview, or Kim Morrissey did it. Sometimes our mind melds.
We all went down a rabbit hole, by the way. How did we go from like this hungry, hangry princess to talking about what is it called? It's called Review, right? It's when it's
Pine Jam Studios, I think.
Yeah, because the same studio animated both.
Get over there.
Yeah.
Which was interesting. When I was in Japan, I was at the Osamu Tezuka Museum, and that town is famous for those shows. Where it's like an all-female cast. And they had all these statues and stuff like honoring it and everything. And I was like, oh, this is super cool.
Yeah.
So anyway.
Yeah. So as far as I know, Tis Time for Torture Princess hasn't been picked up for streaming yet. I hope it does. It looks like a pretty cute comedy. Very like, you know, easy to watch, good production values and some good character design. So
I'm excited for that one.
This next one is a second season of a series that I didn't watch. I bet Geoff has, though, so he can probably tell you what it's about. This is Banished from the Heroes Party, Season 2.
I watched, like, one episode of this one.
Oh, is this the one where it's, like, a bunch of, like, people that got, like, screwed over? Like, with the priest that got run out of town? And The dragon lady?
I think he's running a pharmacy now.
Oh, then no.
I think
there's a lot of these. This is like the this is one of the milder examples of a subgenre I like to call "Don't Come to the Adventurer's Guild Tomorrow," because it's all about, you know, a guy who's an adventurer with a party that takes him for granted, and they think he's the weakest one, and then turns out
I love these characters. They're gorgeous.
But look who's rolling in the booty now. He proved it all wrong.
But yeah, like
compared Elf again, she was dope. Come back. This is cute. This is very cute.
Yeah, this one's more wholesome than a lot of the ones that are just like.
So does he get like all the girls then? Getting all those girls in the countryside at the dance.
Aw, no more pink haired Elf.
Yeah. Okay, and that's the books. So
that Elf's cute. I like that. I like the swimsuit Elf.
Yeah,
I'm giving all of the trailers a little numerical score this time because I keep every time I run into the same problem where by the time we're done with 40, I forget about like 30 of the ones that we watched. And so this is helping me remember how I felt about the
early. I might write that one down. What was that one?
Banished from the Heroes Party season 2. And okay, people are saying that they're married. He only has one girl. Everyone else is just a friend or a sister, not in a weird way. Well, that's nice. Jacki's more concerned about the sister. She is just
his sister. I draw the line. I draw the line there. Like, as soon as it's like weird liking the sister stuff, I love the Eminence and Shadow, but like sometimes with Claire and Sid even, I'm like, don't, you know. But Sword Art Online, I mean, brilliant show. I'd like get into huge debates with people all the time. Like, it was, I thought that was like one of the best shows I'd ever seen when I watched the first season. And then as soon as it got to the brother-sister stuff, I was like, I can't. There's just too much good anime out there. It's like, if something's just like not striking my fancy a little bit, like I can't. There's too much anime out there. So,
well, I know that at this point it is a back of the box feature. You know, it's something that some people look forward to, which is fine. It's whatever. I'm not here to kink shame no one, but I am begging people in the anime industry. I know that there is a childbirth shortage and has been for decades, but I just need you to find one person that has had a sibling and just have them read over your script and just let them know if there's any red flags.
I'll be your Onesan in this instance. I have a little brother, just, you know, I'll proofread that stuff for you in case, you know, you're concerned about.
We are so off track again.
We are. So
we find out we have only 45 trailers to get through. And so all bets are off. Schedule, who needs that?
Yeah. So if you liked Banished from the Heroes Party first season, second season's coming to Crunchyroll in January. This next one we're going to show is actually Crunchyroll co-production, which has had, you know, its ups and downs. I, based on the plot synopsis for this one, I'm interested in it, although I don't know if the production is going to be there. This is a historical one that has to do with like a drug ring in 1874 Tokyo and that kind of stuff. So I mean, I think
there's about to say they better not be selling weed, because that's too much even for,
you know, it's weed. I think it's opium actually.
Yeah, I was gonna say 1874. It's gonna be what's this called again?
This is it is.
No, it's just quiet.
It's really quiet. I can turn it up a little.
Meiji Gekken.
Yeah, this is Meiji Gekken 1874. Okay, that's a decent looking logo. Okay, they're sieging. Character designs are kind of simple, but that can still be good if they look okay in motion.
White haired guy with an eye patch, sign me up.
But he looked a little.
Yeah, that was some.
The animation's not great, but I love a long white haired guy with an eye patch. I mean, like, come on.
Well, I mean, a good story can survive less than stellar production values. So
yeah,
that's true.
Oh no, the goldfish!
What, the goldfish?
This is okay. I have a feeling I'm gonna have to read the whole synopsis to you guys once this is over, because it's not telling you anything.
I mean, I feel like I get the gist, right? You know?
Do you think the silver-haired guy's the main character though in this thing?
No, I think the like black hair guy is the main character.
That guy, the guy who's backwards to us.
Okay.
Right?
Yeah.
I feel like white hair guy is the villain.
You think he's a villain? He does have antagonist vibes, but he could also be like, oh, okay, he's got a full back tattoo. Was that a lion? Or was that like one of those guardian lion dogs come to life?
I'll be honest, all this is doing is making me think I just finally get around to watching Golden Kamuy.
Okay, so I do have to say, someone in the comments said, I think it's Doc George, I'd be like anime set in the period when guns started appearing in Japan. This is giving me, I just finished The Blue-Eyed Samurai.
I was just about to say, this makes me want to
watch. Yeah, and so I think I'm like riding off of this wave. So it's like, I don't know how great that was, but just the fact that it is in that time period really made me intrigued. I do think the animation was a little lackluster, but yeah. I was like, I would give it a shot.
It's an interesting premise, right? Because it's hard to tell what exactly the problem they're trying to stop is, other than crime in general. But like, if it's an opium ring in Tokyo, that's like interesting, because like historically, Imperial Japan exploited the opium trade in China as part of their control of occupied territory and in Korea, I believe. So I don't really know what's going on with that.
Yeah, that trailer didn't really know.
Like, and also there's magic apparently, so
I feel like Blue-Eyed Samurai is a good one to watch instead of that if you feel like it, or There was one from winter last year called Revenger.
Yeah, yeah. I remember that.
By Gen Urobuchi. That one's pretty, that one's a lot better just in terms of animation quality and everything. If you're in the mood for something in the vein of Blue-Eyed Samurai after being on a good kick. One.
Yeah. So fun. Really love Blue-Eyed Samurai.
I'm gonna read this hefty plot synopsis for anyone who is still kind of on the fence about this, just to sort of fill you in, because that trailer didn't do a great job. Okay, so in 1874, it's been 7 years since the start of the Meiji era, and the Japanese government is pushing its policies to catch up with the might of the Western nations. Former Aizu retainer Shizuma Origasa has thrown away his sword and gotten rid of his top knot and is now a rickshaw driver in Tokyo. But his swordsmanship skills from the Boshin War are still alive and well. I don't actually personally know much about the Boshin War, but moving on. Shizuma is recruited into the police force after he ends up thwarting the assassination attempt of a government official. At the same time, Kyoshiro Shirigami is a talented one-eyed swordsman who is a member of the Moriyagumi Yakuza gang that is embroiled in a turf war in Tokyo. The Moriyagumi are working with wealthy merchants in trafficking of opium, and the profits are being paid to a mastermind plotting to overthrow the government to return Japan to a place for samurai.
Wow.
Okay. So I read all that before watching this trailer. I'm like, okay, I can get on board with all of that.
It sounds like a lot, though. Like,
yeah, but it sounds like a great drama, right? A great historical drama.
It does sound like an interesting historical drama. It also kind of strikes me as like, weirdly ahistorical, because like, again, the opium trade was like a foundational part of Imperial Japanese power, so it's like, it's, there's something weird to me about a story where like the opium traders are the bad guys and the, you know, the Meiji era government that was the direct predecessor of Imperial Japan. Just weird. It's weird to me. Yeah.
Yeah.
Plus, we all know that no one in Japan has ever done a drug. So.
Oh yeah. Of course.
Yeah. Right there. Of course. Sorry. Never. when are we going to get a good anime with an eye patched character as the protagonist? Like, I'm trying to think of like a one.
Jackie's so thirsty for an eye patch.
I am.
Where is he?
Long, white haired eye patch protagonist. I'd even take a villain. But it was
either Jubei-chan, the ninja girl.
Well, but no, she wants white hair.
Yeah, but it is somebody with an eye patch and a sword. I'm trying to think of other eye patch heroes.
Ray has an eye patch at 1.2.
If we're talking that, then Chunibyo.
Yeah.
Love Chewing Gum, another delusion.
These are all girls with eye patches, Jacki.
Yeah, you're right. Yeah. Are there any guy patches?
Yeah,
as I'm trying. Main characters.
And people are talking about Blackjack. Does Blackjack have an eye patch?
Oh, Majima, Yakuza. Majima. You should play the Yakuza games.
Majima is love. I love you. The Yakuza games are so
Kenpachi.
Fun.
Kenpachi Zarachi.
Yes, you're right.
The coolest dude in shonen history until Aoi Todo existed, and then he became the second coolest, which is still pretty cool.
People are
King Bradley, but he's not really a hero though. Yeah, right? he's a supporting character to anybody who hasn't seen Full Metal Alchemist yet. If there's anybody who hasn't seen Full Metal Alchemist yet. Bakano's got
Geoff, you gotta remember it's 2023. There are a lot of people that haven't seen Full Metal Alchemist.
That's why I'm saying it. That's so sad.
This is time for me to soft launch an upcoming column I'm planning to do next year called
Hot
the Backlog.
Eye patches?
It's not just eye patches, it's called The Backlog, and it's everything Lynzee didn't watch during like the 2000s era period, and then some of the classics that if people knew I hadn't seen them, they would say I shouldn't have my job.
Like
Full Metal Alchemist.
Huh?
See?
Oh, wait, are we talking Brotherhood or Original?
I haven't seen either of them.
Oh, okay. You're in for a ride.
Wow, you're in for a ride. Sure, that's...
You heard it here first. The executive editor of Anime News Network has never watched any version of Full Metal Alchemist, but I'm currently watching Brotherhood now, so you can't yell at me anymore. Okay. I'm like 15 episodes deep, so...
Someone said that is honestly insane. I mean, I'm just shocked because Lynzee, you're gonna really enjoy it. It is actually the anime when people are like, well, yeah, how should I get an anime? That is always the one I suggest to get. Like, that's the gateway into
anime.
It's hard to think of an anime that's like better to just get somebody into everything that makes specifically shonen battle anime fun and also just general.
Won't drive them away with any.
The plot is basically perfect.
Yeah.
Of Brotherhood specifically.
I'm so excited for you.
Hey, I'm an O3 fan. I think that show is highly underrated.
No, I like O3, I think, has like a lot going for it in terms of cinematicism, and it's got some interesting world building, but you also like absolutely feel the point where it stops being based on the manga and starts being an original story. Like, there's like a clear...
Yeah.
You feel it. And like, what I like about Brotherhood is it's so cohesive and like... It is honestly hard to think of a better written and tighter plot of any long-form story other than like Kurosawa manga. The way everything ties together by the end is so you're gonna have a wild ride. Also, are you caught up on Jujutsu Kaisen?
Yes, I am.
Okay, so you know how like fun it was
in the first season?
Oh no!
Oh, Geoff, I don't know if you know, but neither of us particularly loved the Shibuya arc.
Okay, well, I don't want to litigate that.
I thought it was okay. Yeah.
It's not terrible, but... No, it's...
I just watched the finale the other day, so I've been sitting on thoughts. I'm just sitting on thoughts about the finale for JJK that...
Well, all I wanted to say about that, because that would be a bad argument that would derail the whole thing.
Yeah.
All I wanted to say is, you know how cool everything Mahito did in that entire fight was? From like an animation perspective, and also like, that has very much the same animated energy as what I would consider the best fight in FMA. I don't know how to say it without spoiling things.
All I'm gonna say is like his brother is one of my favorite characters of all time. It has one of Alphonse. The saddest things I've ever seen in anime period to this day. If you ever see like there's memes of it, not memes, like there's just like on stuff honoring it. I don't want to spoil it for you in any way. And Lust,
sure, she's
one of the saddest people I've ever seen in my life. She's one of my favorite villains. Love her. Anyway, everyone's like, we need to derail counter. How many times
how often we just like completely
we have involved. We have covered five trailers. So.
Yeah,
we should get going. I do want to say one more thing on JJK, which is that it is much easier to appreciate when you're binging it. When you guys go back and watch it again, if you go back and watch it again, in the same way that like the first season is a lot tighter when you're just sitting through it, Shibuya and the Culling Game, because I'm seeing people talking crap about the Culling Game, because, and I know the reason that you're talking crap about the Culling Game is because you got into the manga after Shibuya ended and you read the Culling Game week to week, which makes it kind of slow, a little hard to follow stuff. But when everything flows together and you're binging it, that's when it really comes together. That's all I'll say. Jeff, Shibuya is peak though.
Later, okay?
Jeff, I value our friendship too much to let my hot takes loose at this moment. But
that's fine.
Yeah, I was like, we're not opening that up. Next trailer.
All right, so our next one is something completely different. It's not an isekai. This is Hokkaido gals are super adorable. So if you're, you know, into gals.
Yazzy's so hyped for this one.
Now, are we talking like Gyaru gals?
Or yeah.
Like...
Yes. Yeah. She showed me the manga of this and it's super adorable.
That's some pretty music.
Everyone knows Hokkaido is snow. That's how you know people are in Hokkaido, because there's snow.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, it's like girls gorgeous.
I feel like it would be hard to be a gal in Hokkaido because it's cold. Like mini skirts are kind
of. I guess the American equivalent would be like the Minnesota Valley girls are adorable.
Yes.
Yeah. Oh my god, she's gorgeous.
I like the purple haired one though.
Yeah.
Oh,
Yeah. Oh
my gosh, they are so super adorable.
They are super adorable.
There's no lie. There is no lie in the title of this.
She's cute. She's very cute. The purple haired girl was really cute. And I love the pink haired girl. They're all very cute.
Yeah, very cute. Silverlink and Blades doing the animation, so I'd expect it to be, you know, like serviceable and sometimes good, but not like anything. But it's not, doesn't seem like this type of show that you need to do anything super complicated.
No,
you don't need Sakuga for that kind of show. You can just as long as the
what platform again? James B. That one's Crunchyroll. That's a Crunchyroll show. So, what were you saying, James? Sorry.
Oh my gosh, I thought you were talking to me when you said James B.
James.
Me a little bit.
Yeah.
What was I saying? Oh, I said you don't need Sakuga for that kind of show as long as they look good, like you know.
Yeah, Jacki.
Sorry, someone said that the purple-haired girl is a gamer too. So
nice!
I'm adding half a point to the score for that fact alone.
Yeah,
James' scoring system works. None of us know how it works. We won't know till the end. But he's invented something to help him rank these.
I haven't written anything down. What was the
I haven't written anything down yet.
What was the Banished one again? I forgot. I wrote
the Banished from the Heroes Party, season 2.
Okay. That's not the hungry one, right? What was that one?
No, that was 'Tis Time for Torture, Princess.
Okay. That one was the one where it was a bunch of girls, right? With the pink haired girl?
That we just watched.
I'm lost.
It's okay, Jacki. We're just going to go next.
I'm like, just keep on going. I'll figure it out.
Okay. This next one's also a second season. Didn't watch the first season. Jeff, don't know if you did. I can't remember who reviewed it for us, actually, at the top of my head, but this is Tsukimichi, Moonlight Fantasy, season...
Oh, that was me. I've seen
it. Oh, okay. It was James. Yeah.
The show's pretty okay. Yeah,
that's all right. I like the sidekick characters, if I remember correctly.
Okay. Yeah. And it's, like, fairly funny. The humor's, like, pretty consistent.
Okay. So. Yeah, the character designs are nice.
I
mean,
I would have to read the reviews to tell you anything about it beyond the VA, but...
Is the maid also a ninja?
Yeah, I think so.
All of the side characters have like a thing.
So okay. There are, yeah, it's...
One of them's a dragon that's also yeah. like a lady. One of them's a pig.
It's kind of like a wholesome Ari Ferretta type setup, almost, yeah. Where oh, he's okay. like, everyone's like a monster he defeats or something, and they
oh, it's
going to
be two cores for anyone who was
oh,
curious about that.
Oh, no. Okay.
No, someone in the... People in the Twitch chat are also saying the maid is a spider. She's a spider as well.
Yeah, that's right. That's right.
Yeah.
That's actually
yeah.
kind of cool.
So it's all like cute monster girls who turn into humans, and yeah, it's you know, it's a nice little isekai thing. Not
okay. Just kind of
I watched like 2 to 3 episodes of it the season it aired, and I enjoyed it. I would have watched more if I wanted.
There were just other things.
Well, yeah. I'm a little worried about this two cores thing because I don't really remember it having like an especially strong plot. So I don't really know how they're going to fill that many episodes, but I guess it was.
I mean, they've got source material from somewhere, right?
Well, so I like JC staff picked it up and it was all right. So it'll probably keep being all right because that's, you know, the JC staff standard.
Uh-huh. Yeah,
I'm not too worried about two cores for that. It, you know, that's yeah. what they usually do. Yeah.
So this next one is called The Wrong Way to Use Healing Magic, and I assume it's probably someone using healing magic to like kill undead or something like that. Maybe. Okay. I mean, again, I told you guys there's a lot of isekai this season. I tried to break it up as best I could.
I mean, if the word healing is in the title, I assume it's in isekai.
Yeah. So. Isekai in a walled city. Sorry about that.
God, I... It's depressing like how many times I've seen at. That exact character design. Like,
yeah, didn't we just look at the same guy in the previous trailer? Like, he looks. Is this like the new like harem protagonist thing, but it's like blue hair or something?
Yeah,
the cross, like the hair crossing in the middle of the head thing is. Mm-hmm. You know, you can trace every part of his hair to like a different popular isekai yeah. protagonist.
This guy previously in track, maybe?
But, like, he looks almost... I can't place the anime because it's that generic, but, like...
Yeah.
I want an isekai protagonist with, like, a dang-ass freak haircut like Charlie Brown or something. It's like a single little curly on his head.
Or what if he had silver hair and an eye patch? What if it's an isekai protagonist with silver hair and an eye patch? Jackie's dead. She didn't hear me.
Sorry, no, I was listening. Actually, there was some disturbance. Is that on my end? Like, I heard some crackling.
Yeah, I did too. Some kind of.
Yeah, and it threw me off. I don't know whose mic it is, though.
Oh, is it me? Because I didn't hear it.
I think it might be Lynzee. It was like when you were talking. Well, if we hear it again, we'll figure it out.
Okay. Maybe it's
what did you say,
though?
What about a hot silver-eyed or silver-haired eye patch man?
For an isekai protagonist.
Yeah, how has that not been done?
Yeah.
Was it okay? I've never watched Bastard.
I'm not gonna lie, guys. I didn't absorb a single thing about that.
Yeah, I didn't either. I'm sorry. Yeah. I was like,
it was really there was nothing grabbing.
He looks so mid. Oh, you know so who mid. He looks like? Who he looks like exactly like? One sec.
Who?
I became overpowered in another world, and or I got a cheat skill in another world and became unrivaled in this one too. He looks exactly like the protagonist of that, but with blue hair instead of blonde.
Are you able to share your screen?
Not easily, but I can link an image.
Oh, okay.
One sec.
There it is.
Or not, not quite exact. Maybe I'm... But yeah, he looks a lot...
Do you hear
there's a lot of guys with that exact hair. But yeah, there's the Crunchyroll page. For
I thought
it.
That was Geoff's keyboard that we just heard because I wasn't talking.
No, I can get a higher res, but
I heard it again.
Oh wait, no. And who am I thinking of? I know I've seen that exact hair on somebody like really recently.
Geoff, there's been too many of these shows. It's a fruitless search.
It's all blended together. Yeah. Next, okay, I literally did not process any of that.
I remember it at like 3 in the morning tonight.
It just slid off. That just slid off all our brains.
Yeah.
Bye-bye. So this next one is based on a shoujo manga. Ooh. This is the Demon Prince of Momochi House.
So. Okay. I'm intrigued. Oh, she's pretty.
I like the color design. Oh, that, yeah, that's giving me Gankutsuo.
I was going to say, they're doing the Gankutsuo fabric. Yeah.
I love his hair.
Yeah.
Love his hair, the purple hair. Her eyes are amazing.
Okay, so her parents left her the house in the will, but there's three dudes living there for some reason.
What a scenario.
So that's the terrace and its goddesses plot.
Oh, yeah.
He's got great eyes, too. The colors are amazing. I love the colors.
We haven't heard any bangers yet, by the way. Like, what's going on in the theme?
I don't know what's going on. It's low-key giving me Fruits Basket vibes, because remember, like, the dad and the two sons? Or he wasn't really a dad, he was, like, older than them. I forgot, you know, the
snarl. Oh, yeah, and they got some supernatural crap going on with them that they're trying to keep secret. Oh, and their family in one line. Yeah, Fruits Basket. I think you pegged it. It's a Fruits Basket light.
She even looks like Fruits Basket girl.
Yeah.
Yeah, just with blonde hair.
He's gonna transform, you guys.
You mustn't look at me!
Oh yeah!
Oh,
there's gonna be hot.
This is great.
Oh no!
Oh my god, how cool!
You can't look at me. I'm a hot fox boy.
Oh no! I have
what a turn.
Fox ears.
Oh, they all have magic powers.
All the women reject us because we're hot animal boys.
I know. I'm like, what a turn.
It's like in the Phantom of the Opera movie when Gerard Butler took off his mask and he had like a minor skin rash.
Yeah, exactly.
Except in this one, he actually gets hotter.
Yeah.
Oh, they're so broken up about their inability to... Okay, we're just kissing right off the bat.
Lynzee, you didn't say this is going to be an adult.
No warning. Oh, my. That kind of looked fun. That kind of looked fun.
It looked like he was giving her CPR, though. I feel like this is going to be a... You don't think so?
Wow, James critiquing the kiss right now.
No, I'm just saying. I feel like there's gonna be like a, you know, they're gonna wiggle out of the romance. They're gonna be like, oh, that wasn't a real kiss. That was something that we're gonna have to waffle about for.
Or they're gonna be bonded together for the rest of the series, and then like whenever she's in danger, he can sense it, and then he'll show up, and he'll be like, "Why'd you do that? I care so much about you. I can't believe that you would put yourself in that position. It really hurts me." And she'd be like, "Ah."
You know what? There's only one thing better than a white-haired fox demon prince, and it is a white-haired, eye-patched villain. That's all I'm going to say. Moving on.
If anyone wants to write that one down, that was the demon prince of Momochi House.
Guys, so. I think I'm going to write a graphic novel, and it's just going to be a harem anime with all white-haired men, and they're all gonna have like different.
They all have eye patches.
Or scars. They all have eye patches, and they're all gonna be animal demon princes. We'll figure it out. But I'm getting inspiration here.
It's so hard to tell them apart.
One of them has two eye patches.
Which like is five of them.
Yeah. You're right. We'll have a Kakashi or Gojo-esque one, right? Anyway, moving on. Thank you for the inspiration, James.
Okay. So that'll be on Crunchyroll. This next one may also be thirsty. I don't know. This is the new one from Hiroko Seki, the creator of director of Skate Infinity.
Oh yeah.
Okay. So this is her new series. It's a completely original. It's called Bucchigiri.
By the way, Lynzee watched. Correct me if I'm wrong. Skate Infinity with a bunch of NFL players. Correct.
So this is a funny story.
Okay.
Yes, I did watch Skate Infinity with a bunch of professional NFL players. It was Mike Daniels. He plays for the Saints.
It was like five of them.
It was like five of them. Yeah. And they were like, we did like a live stream with one of them was like at training, like on his phone, like drinking a smoothie and stuff. Anyway, they agreed to watch an anime and then meet me on a stream and we would all talk about it. And I picked Skate Infinity because I was like, okay, this looks like it has good production values. It's about skateboarding, so it's going to be really cool. And we'll all watch it together. That show is gay, you guys. That show is super gay.
It's very gay. Yeah.
And I assigned a bunch of NFL players to watch it. To their credit, they all watched it. They watched all of it. And then they sat and talked with me about it, and they were very cool about it. But
You did not expect it to be that gay.
Did not. It is very gay.
So, I need to watch this show.
You do. It's if you really haven't good, seen it Jacki, already, like, it's amazing.
It's very okay. dramatic. Yeah, like,
I'll be honest. When Lynzee recommends shows, they're either like literally make me cry, and then I'm like, why would you put me through that? Or it's like Hypnosis Mike. Mm-hmm. So it's like, I just, and I felt with Skate Infinity, it might be leaning more towards the Hypnosis
Mike.
It
is Mike a little more towards the
Hypnosis Mike. It's not, like, not Hypnosis
Mike. It's not not Hypnosis Mike, but it's not quite, it's not as quite as outlandish, but there is a guy like, who dresses up know. Like a matador to skateboard, and he kills people. Well, kind of with his skateboard.
Yeah. So. Someone said Birdie Wing. Yeah. It, see, I don't like Birdie Wing. And I don't like, I know everyone's going to get at me for it. It's just.
There's a guy with wonderful back muscles.
I know. I guess.
Hey, we're Birdie Wing stands.
Yeah.
Lynzee and James are always like, there's something wrong with you. Anyway, moving on. The chat's already turning on me. Don't hate me.
There's a guy who kind of has silverish hair in it. Like, he's like.
Yeah. It's more.
Almost boyfriend, you know?
Yeah. It's not quite. Birdie Wing ridiculous. Like, the most ridiculous thing is the science man with an AI powered skateboard.
Yeah.
But that's like, you know, that's only a little bit. It's mostly just, you know, they skateboard real hard at each other.
Yeah.
Until someone until falls someone's off. Beliefs are changed, or they get a boyfriend kind of type thing.
Yeah.
It's free with skateboards.
Yeah, it's like free with skateboards.
I definitely can see that.
And the director, I think, also worked on Free. So
yes.
Yeah. So all right. So this is her new one. This is called Bucchigiri. It's gonna be animated at MAPPA. If the trailer doesn't tell us enough about it, I will fill you guys in. But again, completely original show.
Oh my god, I love all of them!
Okay, so he transfers to a school full of punks.
Oh, she's so cute!
Yeah.
I bet she's trouble.
Yeah, okay, that's his boyfriend.
Horrible.
Already calling it.
This one is on the list. I don't know what it's about.
Yeah, no, this is immediately...
What is this one?
This is Bucchigiri, because it's got a question mark and exclamation mark.
Every character.
Oh, but look at the blue-haired guy! Oh, look at that guy!
Oh my god!
Kenichiro, I love him. I'll...
Okay.
Oh man, these yeah, all these.
Oh my god, Marito, I'm in love with you. I'm.
It's kind of reminded me surprise of the of party guys. Trickster, about
oh yeah,
the
by the way,
boys.
What is going on?
There's a genie. There's a genie because there's a genie. They're all serious. Ooh, okay.
I'm sorry. I love this.
Yeah.
I love everything I'm seeing right now.
Yeah, this is this. This looks great. The
this
animation
is amazing. Day one watch for me.
Yeah,
what
me
is
too.
This?
Bucchigiri?
Bucchigiri?
Bucchigiri.
Okay. That's my name.
Okay. Is that a like?
That's how he unleashes his stand.
Yeah.
Amazing.
That looks brilliant.
That
I'm
looks
like
really
super
good,
excited
right?
for that.
The setting, really, like yeah. it, like the character designs are really cool.
Yeah.
The like action seems pretty solid, but it like also the base premise reminds me a lot of Cromarty High School.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Is like one of my all time favorite comedies. You
I
guys
like
don't.
A lot.
Yeah.
That one's going to be streaming on Crunchyroll, and I've also put how to spell it in the chat and in the private chat, Jacki, since I probably wasn't very helpful.
You guys want to see how I spelled it? I spelled it Bucchigiri.
It's Bucchigiri.
I know, it's literally so wrong, but I was like, okay, she said Bucchigiri.
If you guys want to hear me say it again, it's Bucchigiri.
I love that. Yeah. I loved everything I saw. That's instant number one right now. So.
Yes. Yeah. Oh, looking at the time, if you're watching us on Instagram, we're almost up at an hour, so this may die on Instagram. So now's your time to head over to youtube.com/anime news network to continue watching, or over to twitch.tv/GEOFFTHEW.
That's this.
I'm pointing at my name, but it's actually not helpful in this scenario.
Yeah, no, it's not.
I just wanted.
Yeah,
to
go to Geoff. Wait, right wrong way.
Yeah.
Over
twitch.tv/this.
Yeah.
Sorry, I tapped my mic. That's not what I should have done.
So yeah, that looked, I'm writing that down immediately in all caps as it deserves. Bucchigiri.
Yeah, that was that looks so good.
People are really attaching to Bucchigiri in chat as
no Bocchi. Bocchi's not in this show. Yeah,
Bocchi should be in this show. I want to see Bocchi edits of Bocchi fighting everybody in this show. I know the Bocchi AMV people can do it. There is no limits on their powers.
Oh, so heads up for the next trailer. Okay. I'm scared of it. I haven't previewed it before, but it's probably horny. So just putting that out there right now.
We got the warning.
Yeah, this is the only one I know of that's supposed to be the season that's particularly horny and also controversial due to the age of its protagonist. So this is going to stream on High Dive. This is called Gushing Over Magical Girls.
I knew it. Yep.
I will chime in if necessary. I'm pretty sure. So that's the main character. She's in middle school and she loves magical girls.
The title is a pun, you see.
Yeah.
Oh my god, they're so cute.
And then she gets her magical girl powers, but it turns her into a sadistic villainess with her titties out. Here you go.
Oh no.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So she was on the team and now she's not on the team.
She was just a fan of magical girls.
Yeah.
And then she became a villain. And she's exploiting her power to, you know.
I would be
man, this evil army does not
mean guys. Just come on.
This evil army needs like enough of a budget that their soldiers can have both tops and bottoms at the same time.
Yeah, like, we've seen someone in like a string bikini top and separately someone else in a string bikini bottom, and I'm just
clearly they're on a oh my wow.
Yeah.
That poster at the end. Woo!
It's not hiding what it's about, at least. It's not trying to trick anybody.
If they
weren't in middle school, you know?
I know.
That's my only complaint. I don't care if people want to get their rocks off to, like, some sadistic villain magical girl thing. Whatever, that's fine. But just, can she, like, again, not be 13 years old or something? Yeah, like,
I know.
I mean, as an anime fan, you often have to do what I like to call anime math, where, you know, any character that is stated to be a teenager, realistically is, like, 25 as far as their emotional maturity. articulation, all that good stuff. But there's only so far anime math can take you.
You know?
Anime math can only bring you right up to the line, but you know, there's some lines that you probably shouldn't cross.
Yeah, I guess fortunately it was short. It's like, this is what we can get away with on YouTube. Yeah. Trailer's over sort of scenario, I guess. So that was Gushing Over Magical Girls. That'll be streaming on High Dive if you know you want to check it out. This next one is the second season of a show about I feel like this was kind of a trend at a time where there'd be a show about a dude who kind of sucks and then he meets a girl and she fixes him and makes him cool or something like that. So this is bottom tier character Tomozaki second stage. So it's the second season of this. And if I remember right.
Oh, I remember this show.
Yeah. He like meets a girl and she's a gamer and they do games. Nope.
Is she a gamer or
I thought she was.
Right. They play games together and she teaches him that real life isn't a crap game and crap gamers blame the game for their failure. It's one of those I call them self-help waifu. Anime. Like
she's gonna be his wingman, but surprise, surprise, at the end of the show, they're gonna end up together.
I mean, she's not even his wingman. They're just kind of, you know, it's
just trying to get him come out of his shell.
I didn't watch anything other than the first episode, but I remember in the first episode, she was like, "I'm gonna help you get a date." And I was like,
Wasn't kind of like a snafu, my romantic comedy snafu was sort of like this.
Yeah,
what was that one about the club that was full of people who didn't have friends and then
gamers? But I mean, gamers.
Actually not the one I was thinking of, but that may also count.
Oh, you Saikano.
Nope. different one, but that also counts. See how this was a thing? Yeah.
Yeah.
I think one of the girls had like butterfly hair accoutrements, big purplish butterfly hair thing.
Oh, Haganai.
Haganai. Yeah, everyone in the chat. Sorry, I should check chat when I do this. People are like Bokutachi, Haganai. Yeah. Anime Gataris. Yeah, there's a lot of them where it's just like, whoops, that's the next one. Spoiler.
She's cute.
Yeah, there was back when I did Shelf Life, there's a period where I had to review like, it felt like almost a dozen of these, and they really did start to blend together at a certain point.
I mean it's just the same thing as what was it last season? The Angel Next Door Spoils Me Rotten, and that might have been like a couple seasons ago, but it's all the same thing where like a girl just decides that she's going to fix a guy for no particular reason.
Yeah.
Like
takes pity on him or something. Yeah.
And they like insist it's not a relationship for a really long time until it is.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So they're basically like cohabitating.
Our dating story. That's the one. You were experienced. That was not our dating story. That one last season. Same, you know, I mean that one, they are actually dating. So it's a little different, but like, you know,
Yeah. This next one I think is our first villainess. Well, I guess the doctor one was kind of a villainess. She was a villainess and then a doctor and then her villainess self again, but now she's not a villain anymore because she became a doctor. This one is villainess level 99. I may be the hidden boss, but I'm not the demon lord. Anyway, let's watch it. Oh no. Mm-hmm.
She's cute.
She's adorable.
Yeah.
Look at
that horse too hard.
That horse.
Okay, so there's an Atome game.
It's an Atome game with RPG elements. Oh, boy.
Defeat the Demon Lord in the Atome game. Is that a wink?
Oh man, I've seen all those character designs before. This is not a
right.
Sorry, what is her name? Would everyone like to try and read that?
Yumiela Dulkness.
Yumiela Dulkness.
Level 99.
Level
99. It's not her name, but yeah.
Okay, I thought the pink-haired girl was going to be the main character. I'm kind of interested in this girl, though.
Yeah, she's bad. Like, in a good way. Like, she's cool.
Unfortunately, like, it kind of looks like butt.
Yeah.
But...
yeah, true.
I could get behind this character as a main character in something. It's just... kind of looks like butt, so
I agree. It's like so fun to see a protagonist and she's kind of like low
like it is kind of neat to see a girl doing the Cid
evidence
and shadow thing. You know, like I think it has potential. I'm not like the crap animation is the only thing that's pulling me off though.
Yeah,
for those who asked, this is villainess level 99. And there's some extra stuff on there. But if you remember Villainess level 99, she'll appear. That's the show. It'll be on Crunchyroll. And if you didn't pick it up from the trailer, the bit is that she's reincarnated as a villainess character. But in this case, the villainess is also a secret boss. So I guess it's probably one of those scenarios where like you go through an Atome game and you do all the routes and then the secret route unlocks and she's that's like the boss of it.
Oh, know, that's why they have the RPG element. I get it.
Yeah. So people say the manga is very funny, according to Hello Delicious Friend in the chat. So, yeah. I would, if this ends up being as sparse a season for me as it is turning out so far, I might watch it casually.
Yeah.
But yeah, that's kind of where I'm at with that one.
No, what you're going to do is finish Full Metal Alchemist.
Then you're going to watch
Gungrave. No, I'm kidding.
I mean, I could add it to my backlog of shame, which you is kind of the whole point.
Love that anime.
Guys, there's a lot. You could start. I haven't watched Durarara. I haven't watched
Durarara is kind of
overrated. It doesn't hold up very well. I tried to rewatch of it like a year or two ago.
Yeah.
We ended up just not finishing it. We were like,
I don't know if I'd say overrated is maybe the wrong word. It's too long.
We got bored. We're like, oh, okay.
Yeah, it and like the subsequent seasons to the first one are kind of just middling quality because, mm-hmm. you know, they're just continuing the story on a budget.
You've seen Bakano, right?
Yeah, Bakano's way better.
Yeah, Bakano's much better.
I've not seen Bakano.
And so is Dead Mouth Death Play. Okay.
I would say do Bakano instead of Durarara first.
Okay. Well, that one's not like available anywhere, if I remember right. Bakano's like lost to the ether.
You got to buy the Blu-ray for Bakano.
Lynzee, if you say you've seen Bakano. No, I haven't. You guys can start. If you throw in any really big series that was released between like 2006 through about 2011-ish, I may not have seen it.
Hold on, in Lindsay's defense,
Death Note? Was...
Yes, you've not seen all of it, but I know how it ends.
Wait, was that
2004?
Well, that's one of those ones, you basically absorb it via osmosis at this point.
Well, like... Full Metal Alchemist was kind of the same.
I love Death Note, and I've rewatched Death Note recently, and I think it still holds up.
Have you seen Haruhi? Yes, I've seen Haruhi. I watched that as it was released. Soul Eater, no, I haven't seen Soul Eater.
Oh my god, I love Soul Eater.
You guys can get, this is a fun game. We could do this instead of the trailer watch party. I'm just like letting it all out now.
In Lindsay's defense though, that was such a hard time to watch anime.
Yeah.
Like, you know, wonderful.
I was torrenting, guys. Shh. Yeah. I didn't work for ANN yet.
Yes.
It
was hard to get a hold of anime. That's all.
Certain Magical Index. I've seen like the first episode of Certain Magical Index and none of the rest.
Yeah. Yeah.
Index is a big time investment. That's fair. That's like Fate levels.
Have you seen Fate?
Which one?
Wednesday night.
Fate. I've seen the original Dean, and I've seen. Oh. I have seen UFO Table. I've seen Ouran. You guys don't got to worry about Ouran. I have seen all.
Okay,
of
I actually haven't seen Ouran.
Full Metal Panic. I watched some of that, but I don't know if I've seen all of it. Yes, I've seen Black Lagoon.
You've seen Kill la Kill.
Yes, I've seen Kill la Kill. Kill la Kill was out.
That was 2013. Yeah, I mean, it sounds like you had like a similar experience to me, where like you just got like. Little bit burned out on trying to watch anime back when it was expensive before Crunchyroll.
Yeah, I got burned out, and a lot of life stuff happened. So
yeah,
there's just a lot of things that I haven't seen. Samurai Pizza Cats, I watched that on TV originally, you guys. I'm old. Come on. Gurren Lagann, yes, I've seen Gurren Lagann. Oh, okay, we're gonna go on to the next trailer now, but you guys can keep doing this and I'll keep an eye on it.
We'll all weigh in. This is fun. Chat, you're amazing.
Yeah. I'm writing all these down. You'll get to Bleach. I've seen the first 40 episodes. Okay, let's go.
The only good part of the Bleach.
Yeah. That's kind of true.
I've seen the Soul Society arc, and then I stopped.
Just read the manga. The manga is like, I can't recommend it enough as a, but yeah.
Okay, like as a last one, Get Backers. I didn't know anyone still cared about Get Backers. So I mean, that's cool.
That brings me back.
Yeah, that gets me back.
Yeah.
Gunsmith Cats. I based my entire personality off Rowley Vincent as like a young teen.
Okay, someone put Gintama. I have wanted to watch Gintama so badly, and I have.
It's incredible. It's just so long, but it's amazing.
Yeah,
That's my big backlog. White Whale. That and. Legend of the Galactic Heroes.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
I've got the box set. I just got to set aside 3 straight days to watch it all.
Yeah, right? Yeah. All right. This next one is going to be airing on Crunchyroll. It's called Delusion Monthly Magazine.
Okay. Ooh.
So probably a manga-related thing.
Yeah, I would think so. I think it's about a bunch of weirdos working at a manga magazine. This sure is
character concept art over motion graphics.
This isn't animated, guys.
This is rough. Yeah, I was like,
that's an Afghan, one of the dumbest
dog
breeds.
Very cute. Let's give him that. That's a very cute dog.
It's a cute dog, but he's dumb.
Look, they all got catchphrases.
Oh my gosh, why is he dumb? He didn't
do it. Afghans are not smart dogs. They're just not smart dogs. God. Did that guy just turn into a tiger? Did anyone see that?
He did. Oh! Yep. This looks like goofy fun. But like, I am not encouraged by how little animation there was there.
Yeah, I don't know what I just saw, really. Do you guys want me to read the synopsis for this one? Because I can do that.
I mean, that didn't tell us anything. So
that didn't tell you anything. So the story takes place in a town of most city in a certain country. On the second floor of an old building is a publishing company that puts out a periodical called Delusional Monthly Magazine, a science magazine featuring articles about shocking, bizarre events and inexplicable phenomena that make even scientists throw up their hands in defeat. So it's like an occult magazine sort of deal. Its staff consists only of a beautiful editor-in-chief, oh, thank you, and one editor, Taro J. Suzuki, who are joined by a grade school-aged assistant, Jiro Tanaka, and his dog, Saburo. The editorial department is always empty, and Taro, Jiro, and Saburo are usually hanging out in Rock, a coffee shop on the first floor. One day, the scientist, Goro Sato, visits them for a consultation, and therein lies the beginning of the outlandish new story.
Okay.
So
next.
Yeah, that was most city. Could be fun. The second season to The Fire Hunter, one of the most disappointing things I watched recently. It's based on novels by the same author as The 12 Kingdoms. So I was expecting that. And Mamoru Oshii was working on the script, whose name is still there. It is very disjointed, and the animation fell apart pretty hard during the first season. And the main character is that girl, and she kind of is lame and whiny and doesn't do anything the whole time. And okay, like the wolf running there.
Still seems like the animation's falling. I really like the world of this one, though. Like,
The first episode.
I read the books in a heartbeat, but yeah, the animation was a mess. There are tree people. I don't even know where to like start explaining this.
So I never finished the first season, but it does. Like the art style was really impressive at first, but it really seems like they're like the whole production's buckling under an inability to keep it up.
Yeah, had a really good opening theme. I'll give it that.
The first episode was incredibly strong.
Yeah,
it's just.
Yeah, I think that was one of the standout premieres of that season.
Yeah, and they just had, there's like politics between different tribes or different elements, and then, you know, there's the goddess and maybe a satellite / comet and evil beasts and like things. It was almost too much, too, like to keep kind of track of the lore.
I ended up in, like, as far as fantasy letdowns that season, I feel like Giant Beasts of Ars was a much bigger letdown.
Oh yeah.
So like to me, I was like, I still enjoyed that one a lot because the world building was still, you know, solid for what
now,
I watched.
Now did Ars get bad or did it just become mush?
Kind of just turned into a mess, yeah.
That's what happens.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, so that was Fire Hunter season 2. I won't be watching it. Please don't vote for it. Don't make me write about it more. I'll just give it to someone else. So, Jacki, you're muted.
I said, Lynzee, you've seen Elf in Lead, right?
Yes, I've seen Elf in Lead.
Good. Someone put that and I was like, ooh, Lynzee, you got to watch that one.
Yeah, I did. Okay, I saw Madoka Magica. I've seen all of Madoka Magica. I've got the imported Blu-rays. I was kind of obsessed with that show
In my chat, somebody made like a good point about Ars, which is it's like a very mid JRPG inspired 90s anime, and it's fun if you watch it like one of those. And I kind of
What was that really good fantasy anime based off of? Was it Rage of Bahamut? Is that
Rage of Bahamut's amazing? Yeah, that's both seasons of that are kind of like anime Pirates of the Caribbean. Weirdly, they got that kind of like character.
I've not seen Brunhilde, but that's probably not gonna make it. Like, that's not one I feel like. I mean, it's not like it's bad or anything, guys, but like the point of the column will be like egregious oversights. So I wouldn't put that one up there. Someone else asked about Hunter x Hunter. I have watched 0 episodes of Hunter x Hunter. Also, while we're here, I mean,
That, like, right there, that explains why you don't like Jujutsu Kaisen. You don't... You don't, like, in the last Mahito fight, right, there is the most galaxy-brained Hunter x Hunter reference in existence. It's so, there's, like, so many levels to it. Okay. But Hunter x Hunter is just peak. Hunter x Hunter is, like, you need to watch that more than Fullmetal Alchemist.
I haven't watched any Yu Yu Hakusho or Naruto.
Call me in Hunter x Hunter, because I've watched,
well, Lynzee, if you watch the Netflix Yu Yu Hakusho, you can get through the whole series in, like, 5 episodes.
James, I read your review.
Here's the thing. I didn't read Hunter x Hunter until 2 years ago, and now I'm looking at myself, all past versions of myself until, actually, yeah, no, a year and a half. But yeah, like, all past versions of myself that did not know Hunter x Hunter, I'm like, what's wrong with you? You should have.
It's so slow in the I've watched 50 episodes and I'm like, I don't get it.
No, it's okay, so 50 episodes. So I'm thinking, like, manga terms, but it is slow, I guess, but no. It's
I love the characters. I think I could like the world. It's just like not it's never hit me.
So what part did you get to? Because when you say 50 episodes, I'm not sure.
I met Killua's brother.
Oh, you only met Illumi. Okay, so you didn't even get to Hunter x Hunter.
But that's so not even episodes to, before?
The real Hunter x Hunter does not
it was
start.
Like 50. Am I not? Maybe I'm like 20.
No, that's I think like 24 episodes, because yeah, okay, Illumi shows up at the end of the exam arc, at which point they haven't even established or explained the power system, but like it is good. The thing about Hunter x Hunter is all the stuff that you've watched is actually way better than you think it is, but you will not understand how much incredible stuff Togashi was setting up until you get, I'd say another like 15 episodes is probably what you have to watch. Once you get to the battle tower, and they explain how Nen works, that is when Hunter x Hunter starts picking up, and it never drops off. It's
so
just
many episodes. That is a lot of episodes.
It is a lot of episodes.
For an anime not to hit after 14 episodes, I guess I only watched 14. All I remember was, like, I felt like I had invested a lot of time, and then I was like, all right, I gotta let go here.
I understand. Yeah. I watched on Netflix, and I fell off, like, right after the exam arc, when they go to Killua's house, that's that for me. I was like, oh, this is what it's going to be. I felt like it was really slowing down, and I didn't like that. But that only lasts like 3 episodes. He gets out of that really fast, and then like, there's a training arc followed by one of like top 5 greatest story arcs ever written in any manga ever.
It's the Chimera Ant arc, right? That's the one I've been...
No. York New City. York New City is the first peak Hunter x Hunter arc. Then there are a couple arcs that are merely top 10 shonen arcs of all time. And then we get back to the top 1 with the Chimera Ant arc, which is the greatest tragedy probably in the history of the entire genre. I know some Saint Seiya fans will disagree with me on that. But, it's the Chimera Ant arc is impossible to describe how good it is, but it's like, it kind of starts from the premise of like, what if the thing from the movie The Thing washed up on the shore of like a very reclusive country where like news doesn't get out and just had some time to develop. And then it goes from there to like, yeah, it's, I don't want to spoil anything, but it's like,
I mean, it's on my to-do list, but like the longer shonen ones, like at least what I'm thinking about, I don't.
Hunter x Hunter
probably, like,
is
touch, like the first 10, like the first core or something, but I don't I don't know. They're just a huge time investment for what's
for sure, for
like,
sure, for sure. Yeah, like I get it. Like Hunter x Hunter specifically is just like everybody talks about how good it is, and you know, like with One Piece, where like it is that good, and it takes like a while to get there. But there's some stuff, and it's more the amount of time that you invest in it that makes it as amazing as it is. In Hunter x Hunter's case, it's got that time investment that like sucks you in, but then also it's literally so tight and layered, and there are so many things going on with all the characters. It's, you could argue it doesn't even have a protagonist, because Gon is like there and he's kind of like the Goku figure, but like there's so much going on. Just get to York New City. That's all I'll say. Get to York New City, the big heist arc.
Yeah.
That one is where everything that really sets it apart comes together. And it's really that good on the same, not like on the same level of One Piece, where, but like on the same level of FMA, where it's just like that good as everybody says it is. Yeah.
I like, Starkiller was like, Geoff is in his own world. Yeah, Geoff was like,
I
theorize and analyze. You've sold me though. I will give it another try. I'm going to give it another try just because you spoke so passionately about
Thank me next season.
Okay.
This next one that we're gonna watch, we're going to start powering through these a little bit, guys. We're only on number 16. This is Ishura.
Ishura?
Ishura.
How many do we have?
This is number 16.
Lynzee, how many do we have?
25.
25? 45. Ah! No more talking.
Okay, so they're all the strongest. Okay, I saw some questionable CG lizard man. Questionable CG dragon.
Skullman.
Okay. There's a lot of CG going on, actually.
No, I'm not gonna lie, I love the monsters. It's terrible CG, but I love what I've seen of the, I wish
it's, they were, I mean,
like,
it's
not that bad.
I would say
it's
terrible.
Like, that's,
I don't know, guys.
There's some good deformation to, you know, like the way that the spear is bending when he's
I was gonna say the choreography is good and the movement is good enough that even though the models aren't like, you know, really high up there.
I mean, the models just aren't cohesive with the 2D aesthetic. Yeah, that's, I think, the problem.
Yeah.
But it's like...
But I mean, the animation itself is pretty solid.
Like, yeah,
this is nice, really high quality.
Yeah. Yeah.
Really? The beginning made me doubtful. Now it's convincing me.
Oh, man, I love that. I don't know who that dude is. Dragon with the goggles, I love him. I want to take him home.
Monsters are
another
really
show to add to the list. Yeah, Dragon with a shotgun.
I'm on that one. I'm on that
Haunted
one.
How's the story though? That's gonna be the big question. I did really like the world.
Yeah,
but I don't know, of those lizard monsters in the beginning.
I can tell you about the story if you'd like.
Okay, let's hear
everybody.
It.
All right. So Ishura, in a world where the Demon King has died, a host of demigods capable of felling him have inherited the world. A master fencer who can figure out how to take out their opponents with a single glance. A lancer so swift they can break the sound barrier. It's pronounced Wyvern, isn't it? Wyvern?
Wyvern
who fights with three legendary weapons at once. An all-powerful wizard who can speak thoughts into being. An angelic assassin who deals instant death. Eager to attain the title of true hero. These champions each pursue challenges against formidable foes and spark conflicts among themselves. The battle to determine the mightiest of the mighty begins. So it's a tournament arc, I guess, right?
Also, yeah. Dragon with a shotgun. So
yeah, everyone's raving about Dragon with a shotgun. The monsters are cool. I really like the world. So.
Yeah.
But I don't know. We'll see. What was that one called?
That one's called Ishura. Ishura. Ishura.
Yeah.
Wait, what was it?
Ishura.
Okay. Wait, was that Studio Passion? Really?
I didn't take very extensive notes this time because I was so busy. So I don't know. Usually I have the studio for every single one, but
yeah, people
I didn't
are commenting that in the.
Oh, I mean, it very well could be. It kind of looked similar to other work they've done.
Yeah, yeah, it is. It is. Okay. Oh, that's interesting. They make some good stuff. And
yeah.
What's something they've done?
They did Interspecies Reviewers. And High School DxD Hero.
Not the one I was going to bring up. I was going to bring up the one that was like trying to figure out who the betrayer was.
Roka no Yusha, yeah. Which
that was back when Pony Canyon was trying to release their own anime stateside. That didn't last very long.
That,
anyway,
That was like one of the biggest disappointments for.
I wish it got a second season, actually, but yeah. It had a girl with silver hair and an eye patch in it, Jack.
Yeah, that's true. Hey. It did.
What was this one?
The one we just watched was the one we're talking about. Jeff, do you remember what the localized title was?
Roka no Yusha, Braves of the Six Flowers.
Braves of the Six Flowers. Yeah.
Yeah. Yazzie and I both really do not like that show. For me, my big problem with it is it's a mystery story based in a magical world that.
It doesn't give you all the clues. It's not fair play.
Yeah, so it doesn't explain the magical mechanics at the heart of the mystery until the mystery is revealed, and it's really frustrating.
We're not talking about Snowman here. All right, so this next one is my instant death ability is so overpowered.
What? No kidding.
We got to just say next if we don't like the anime. That's what we're doing.
I don't know. This guy looks like he's taken out a military institution as a child with his...
Why I mean, if it lets him be truly OP and he just gets to, like, wipe out whole armies, that's...
Alpha Omega. Oh, look, it's an Evangelion elevator reference.
Cute dog.
Okay.
Cool. Oh, man, is this not...
He opened a gate in his mind.
Oh.
And then said die, and now there's...
Okay.
What is happening?
I don't really know.
I like her design.
Oh, I love her.
Oh yeah, yeah, that drill girl is cute.
Yeah.
She's cute.
Yeah.
Girls are cute. Cute girls.
I like that monkey guy there too.
Oh, is that a monkey? I thought he was like a girl.
She looked cool too. She kind of looked like A&N's mascot.
Yeah, kind of. Like, what do you guys think of his little hair flippies?
I don't like his hair flippies. Those bother me.
They're very Pokemon. I think for some reason they're gonna be Pokemon.
What? So there's Mecha, there's Monster.
This guy sounds over it.
This is one of those ones where if it wasn't animated like crap, it would look really good.
Yeah.
It doesn't look awful. It looks fine.
The character designs are carrying it. It's
stiff.
Yeah.
It's stiff.
Yeah.
Next.
Okay. This next one is one that I think
card game anime hair. Jeff wants
to see this. He's planning to watch it.
Oh my gosh!
This is delicious in dungeon.
It actually looks. We had cardboard cutouts at the A&N booth at Anime NYC, and I just thought it looked cute.
Yeah.
I'm excited to see this. I haven't seen this trailer.
So the main guy's sister, Fallon, has been eaten by a red dragon, but it takes him a long time to digest, so he and his party, plus a dwarf who joins, go into the dungeon to rescue her, and they're going to eat monsters along the way.
This looks fun. I like this. This looks fun to me.
Honestly, it feels very low stakes, we'll say that.
The last cooking isekai I reviewed, I'm in it for the recipes for the most part.
Yeah, yeah. That was campfire cooking in another world, right?
This is cute. I like this.
There are recipes from campfire cooking that I make to this day.
Trigger is definitely bringing the trigger in this one.
Did someone's head just get blown off? Okay, yeah, I was like...
It got lasered. Laser sniped or something.
I also like dragon. How the animation's very cute, you know, and I don't know, like some body parts are exaggerated and stuff like that. It's cute. All right, I'm writing it down.
So for those of you who are worried, Netflix is going to release episodes week to week for this. So it's not a Netflix dump where they put all the episodes at once. It's going to be one a week.
And it's two cores straight, which is...
Nice.
I believe. Which means we've gone from like decades of oops all isekai to like two top tier straight fantasy series that are two cores long each, two seasons back to back. It's wild.
I will definitely watch that one with my husband. I bought him the manga quite a while back because he's the cook in the house, and we enjoyed watching Food Wars together for food the Wars, food.
So fun.
Yeah. And so I think he'll like that one as well. He's also a big D&D guy. So I will write down Dungeon Meshi. As someone who saw the first, I think it was the first two episodes, it's, you know, like I said, the stakes are kind of low. So just like keep that in mind. Like people are coming into it with trigger expectations of like big bombastic. It's not really like that. There's not even like fighting every episode or anything like that. It's kind of chill. So
is it like Frieren? Because I've been loving Frieren.
It's not as Frieren isn't chill necessarily. It's not as kind of
pretty chill.
Yeah, I was gonna say
Frieren's a drama.
Drama, but like it's not.
Frieren is so chill. What are you?
It is also
about?
Kind of mellow in its own way as well. I would say
this is
one...
much more mellow though than Frieren is probably. What, I could see
one
that.
Might call Frieren a mellow drama.
Get out!
That was so bad. That was it. Was kind of good because it was so bad. Yeah. Like I
no, that was good. I'm gonna stand up for that one. That was great.
Thank you, James.
I appreciate you having my back.
Oh my god! Somebody put the drum sound. Anyway, next.
All right, this next one is going to be streaming on High Dive. I think it's a little sexy, but like not weird sexy. I think it's kind of got some dom sub energy going on with it, or I'm way off, and that's just telling you things about me. So here's Chained Soldier.
Well.
Okay.
I mean, I. If
for
I had
all of you who fell in love with Ezdeath, here's your new Ezdeath.
Reminds me a little bit more of.
She's definitely got Ezdeath.
From.
Like you're going to see a lot of cosplay of her.
Recreator. I'm blanking on the name of the military uniform princess from Recreators right now, but it reminds me.
Oh,
of
gosh.
Oh, yeah, I know what you're talking about.
That's
okay,
a show I need to get. Is that still on Amazon?
Yeah.
Is that
still I know Recreators. I know the name of the anime. I just blanked on her name for a sec. I'll tell you, right? Yeah.
This looks good-ish, right?
Like, yeah, it looks good-ish. I totally agree with that.
This could be a 7 or an 8 out of 10. That's my impression.
Yeah, I agree
right
with
now.
That.
This seems
like,
like
he kind of transforms into like a tokusatsu hero or something. See? Kind of.
This seems like
though.
The kind of show, Geoff, where you could delineate between good trash.
Yeah,
there's a lot of makeup.
For sure. Yeah. For sure. Definitely looks like trash, but it looks like my kind of trash, honestly. All right, sitting. Oh, man.
Okay. Yeah, I mean, I'm interested enough in it. This looks like maybe a good time.
I like that CG Birdman doing a Naruto run. That's good. Do they have like Pokemon or like stands or whatever? Is that the thing?
I'll read the synopsis here in a second. So it looks like.
What's it called again? What's the name?
Chained Soldier. So it's kind of easy to remember. And otherworldly spaces known as Demon Cities appeared in various parts of Japan, and those who partook in the peaches, growing there gained unique abilities, but only if they're girls.
Okay.
One day, a down-in-the-dumps high school boy named Yuki Wagura suddenly gets lost at the entrance of a demon city. There, he meets Kyoka Uzen.
Wait. I'm just.
This is giving
peaches,
me some Shin Megami
peaches in quotes.
Tensei vibes.
Is this a series where you get superpowers by eating ass? Is that what it's called?
Jeff, you're not supposed to say it out loud. It's subtext.
It's subtext.
I'm sorry.
Was it the first thing I thought when Lynzee said peaches? Yes.
Peaches. I'm not, you know what? There's a song I could sing here that I'm not gonna.
Peaches
so,
and cream?
I was thinking millions of peaches for me, that one.
Oh, okay.
So anyway, Kyoka Uzen is the beautiful leader of the 7 programs of the Magical Defense Corps, who orders him to become her slave. I am writing it down, but covertly.
The one that we just saw?
Yeah.
Yeah, that looks,
Someone's saying it's a change of pace for Protag to be a slave rather than a slave owner.
That's true.
Hey, if the harem girls get to have a little bit of personality, I am all for it. So
yeah, that's I mean, actually, yeah, the last time I saw that in a harem, it was Familiar of Zero, which is like quite good.
Yeah.
Proto Isekai.
Wait, was that the... Oh, no, that's not the sequel to Grimoire.
No.
Familiar of Zero is about this mess up, this screw up student at a magic academy who, during their familiar summoning test, where everybody else summons, like, some cool magical creature,
he just summons like, the mommy demon, right?
Yeah. No, the pink-haired tsundere, voiced by Rie... Is it Takahata? Summons Saito. I've watched all of it. I haven't watched any of the other things, but I've seen all of the...
You've seen all of the Familiar of Zero, but you haven't seen Hunter Hunter FMA.
Yeah.
Awesome.
I have my priorities straight, okay?
I respect that, actually. Familiar of Zero is like really, I think the first harem isekai to my knowledge. So it's like pretty significant.
We could deep dive into it, but you can blame Familiar of Zero for the isekai trend. We've got like an essay up about it. But before we get like too deep into that, I want to do like one more trailer and then we're going to take like a quick intermission break for anyone who needs to go potty. So let's do one more.
Someone said waiting for Jacki to say next.
Oh, it's was Chain Soldier the author of Akame ga Kill? Okay.
Sorry, I should have led with that. If you liked Akame ga Kill, this is based on a manga by the same person.
That connects a lot. It all makes
a little more sense now, right? All right.
I love edgy crap like that. Okay,
it's going to be a good time.
I do not love edgy crap like this, though.
This is Classroom of Heroes Classroom of the Elite, season.
Yeah. The show's still going?
Yeah. These two seasons were like greenlit at the same time, too. So, you know, they really bet on it that it was going to be a thing.
I mean, it's real popular among the TikTok kids.
Oh, is it?
Understand. Yeah, it's... younger generations watched a lot of it. So, man, I've already forgotten so much about this show.
I had a freelancer like marathon the first two seasons so that we could get a review up of the first episode of this when it was at Anime NYC. And I felt kind of bad because I knew he was wasting his time.
It's
sick of ANN, you know, but
yeah, it's not as bad as Liar Liar.
Okay.
That's what I'll say as far as Baka and Test knockoffs go. There are worse ones out there now.
Yeah.
It's real stupid.
They just showed a teacher walking with a baseball bat and it seemed implied he was going to hit one of the students with it, but there's so much glaring in the show. Everyone is just glaring at each other.
I was going to say, for anyone that isn't familiar with the source material, I imagine this trailer is incomprehensible.
Yeah.
Because it's just like random shots of whatever.
Yeah. They're like, oh, I got plans. At last the first year arc will be completed.
Seasons and they finished their first year of high school. Okay.
Yeah. I mean, to be fair, there were a lot of Machiavellian mind games going on in that first season. I can't remember any, but like they keep saying that the main character is such a genius. Every episode, someone's like, wow, that guy's so smart. He's just the smartest guy. They keep telling it to you, so it must be true. He must have had some really good plans. I just can't remember them right now. Because they're so galaxy brain.
Oh,
definitely, because it was just excruciatingly boring.
Okay, everybody, this is where we're going to take a quick intermission to replenish our snacks and drinks and bathrooms and anything else. I'll mute this.
All right, I will be back in a bit.
Yep. See you soon, everybody.
I'll hold down the fort until everyone gets back. I thought this was a rubber ducky, but it's actually a squishy pink dinosaur. What other strange things do you guys have on your desks? Or, hey, this is a good time for you guys to start asking me about more shows. I did see Claymore earlier, and I have seen Claymore. I have not seen March in something romance. Have I watched De Grey Man? No, I have not seen De Grey Man. Any Macross? I watched Macross on the Sci-Fi Channel a long time ago, but I don't remember. I think it was one of the movies. Black Butler? Yes, I've seen Black Butler. Kaiba? No, but I own it on Blu-ray. Higurashi When They Cry? I've seen all of that. Psyche K? No. Yes, I have seen Duel. Yes, I've seen the first two seasons of Kimi ni Todoke. Gundam, Wing, and Witch from Mercury. Darker Than Black? No. I've seen the original Bastard. I keep meaning to watch Mushishi, but have not gotten all the way through it. That one will definitely be on there. I've seen all of Fushigi Yugi. I have not seen Ghost in the Shell Standalone Complex, so that's definitely one to go on there. Serial Experiments Lane? Yes, I've seen all of that. Your Lie in April? No, I haven't seen most of that. Death Parade? Yes, all of it. Boku no, seen all of it. Clannad? I have seen all of that. I've seen some episodes of Boondocks when it used to air on Adult Swim. Overlord? No, not really interested in it. Haibane Renmei? Yes, but I don't remember it that well, but I have seen all of it. Maoyu, a couple episodes. Harvey,
is that
yes.
The candy one? Is that the candy show?
No, that's Dagashikashi. Okay. Ghost Stories? Yes. Barakamon? No. Boogie Pop Phantom? Only the original. Escaflowne? Yes. All of Revolutionary Girl Utena? I have not seen all of Princess Jellyfish. I need to. Nadesco? I've seen a lot of. Beck, no, but it's on my list. Psychopass, yes, but only the first season because it's the only one that matters. Cardcaptor Sakura, I've seen all of it. Hajime no Ippo, no. Holic, yes, I've seen all of Holic. Chrono Crusade, no, I forgot about that show. That's got a nun in it, right? Hitman Reborn, no. Humanity Has Declined, I started it but did not finish it. Angel Beats, no. Kaguya-sama, yes, I've seen all of Kaguya-sama. That's out so far. Kyoso Giga, no, but it's on my list. Technolize, no, but it's on my list. Elfin Lead, yes. Punchline, no, I didn't watch that. I haven't seen Katanagari. Wolf's Rain, like some of it, but not all of it. Showa Genroku Rakugo Shinju, yes. Princess Tutu, no, but I own it, so that'll be on the list for sure. Nichijou.
Have you seen Gantz? Or Gantz?
Yes, I've seen all of Gantz. Or Gantz. Oh, yeah. Nichijou, no. I'm in love with the villainess. The production quality just didn't hold up for me. I didn't watch it. Penguin Drum, seen all of it. I've seen all of the Ikuhara stuff, guys. No worries there. Yeah. Rave, no. Read or Die, just the OAV. My Bride is a Mermaid. I think I watched some of that. Deno Coil, own it, but haven't seen it. Gintama, I have not watched. Haunted Junction, maybe, but it's been a really long time. Call of the Night, just the beginning of it, but it was good. Azumanga Daioh, yes. Golgo 13, no. Land of the Lustrous, yes. Uma Musume season 2. No, I haven't watched the Horse Girl stuff. I think I'm okay with that. Monogatari is a big blind spot, so maybe I'll try to do like the first season for this and see what happens.
Just don't watch it around polite company.
Exactly. Usagi Drop, yes. Chihayafuru, yes, but not the third season. Moribito, no. Kaiji, no. Kino's Journey, no. Joshi Raku, no, but I remember it.
Lindsay, your mic is so much distortion. So much distortion.
It sounds like
it might be like a cable or a plug.
Yeah.
I don't know, guys.
Is it me? Am I the problem?
You sound fine to me. Original Helsing, yes. Scry, just a little bit. Hack Sign, no, but it's got a great soundtrack. Akagi, no. Outlaw Star, yes.
Jin King of Bandits.
Oh, Outlaw Star. Pump the brakes. Let's have an appreciation moment for Outlaw Star.
I think I've seen some of it. Akira, of course I've seen Akira. 12 Kingdoms, some of it. Tatami Galaxy, no, and I need to. Daily Lives of High School Boys, no, but it's pretty funny. Maid Sama, that would be up my alley. I think I've read the manga for that, though. I already said I haven't seen Princess Tutu. I haven't seen the Kara no Kyokai movies, and I need to do that. Ascendance of a Bookworm, no, but Tenchi Muyo, I've seen like all of Tenchi Muyo. Shakugan no Shana, I think I watched the first season. Are you guys impressed that I know what all of these are, though?
Yeah, I'm impressed. I heard you. Jackie's the problem? Is it me?
What?
No. Well, honestly, one of the problems of being an anime critic is that you spend so much time writing about anime, researching about anime, putting together articles about anime, corralling an insane group of freelancers about anime, that it doesn't leave a lot of time to watch stuff that you're not actively like needing to watch for whatever is currently happening. That's why my backlog has just gotten out of control, where it's like every time I sit down to watch anything that I'm not covering, my brain is like, you should be watching the new episode of this.
Yeah, exactly. Moriarty the Patriot. I've read the manga for that, and I think I've seen most of the first season. Now and Then Here and There is a masterpiece, and I've seen all of
it. Yes, I was about to ask.
God, Now and Then Here and There. One of the best.
Kamisama Kiss. Yeah, no, I haven't seen it, but I know it's about. Steins Gate, I've seen all of it. No, Kuroko's Basketball. Yes, to Code Geass. Natsume's Book of Friends. No, Ergo Proxy. No, Vivi. No, Gigantor. No, Nichijou. No, Rosafon. Yes.
What's the one about the girl who has the like the demon boyfriend? It's not Inuyasha, obviously. Oh my gosh. Oh, I'm having such a brain fart. I watched all of it with my wife, and we
loved
it.
There's so many demon boyfriend anime.
Oh god.
I'm sure Mark comes in like a lion. No, that one was so sad. Sayon Koku Monogatari, some of it. I Want to Eat Your Pancreas. No, I haven't seen that movie. DN Angel, I know a lot about it, but haven't seen most of it. Made in the Abyss, I've seen all of it. Yuma-kun, no. Lucky Star, no, I have not seen Lucky Star. King of Bandits, Jing, no, but I'm familiar with it. Magi, no. Mononoke, yes. Someone just wrote my name. I think they're just upset with me at this point. Oh, okay. I'm glad I'm forgiven for seeing all the Ikuhara stuff. Alice in Borderland, no, but that's the live action supposed to be really good. Okay, I'm pretty far behind now at this point. So sorry, guys. All right, let's Zegapain. No, but back in the old days, I actually did script editing for a fan sub group on the last episode of that, and that's all I've seen of Zegapain. So without further ado, King of the Hill. Yes, let's move on to
the
show about Mahjong. Steve put this as his most anticipated. I did not have the heart to tell Steve that it looks like ass. So here you go. Home no Michi.
You know, every time I start a new game of any Yakuza game, I tell myself this is going to be the one where I learn Mahjong.
And it never is?
Nope. Nope. One of these days.
Look at the little bird.
As far as I can tell, this is just about girls hanging out playing Mahjong.
That blonde one looks like Chisato from Licorice Recoil. But at home, you know?
Yeah.
Chisato at home.
Yeah.
No
one's going to remember that show here in about 40 minutes when we're like done with this, I think. But
yeah,
I was Kono Michi, and it's about Mahjong.
That was designs by the Quintessential Quintuplets mangaka?
Oh, okay.
That's disappointing, honestly.
Yeah, that makes it worse.
You'd think he would do better. Huh.
Here is the trailer for season 5 of Kingdom. I feel like this is the third season of Kingdom we watched a trailer for during these trailer watch parties. I still haven't watched Kingdom, you guys.
Me neither.
Here's Kingdom. Like, the designs and the color and everything are great, but I'm sorry, we're like 5 seasons in now and I just can't.
It's a lot.
Find the time to get into it.
Yeah. Not with all the anime you guys just listed that I haven't seen. I don't have time for Kingdom. These guys all look very.
They got so much chin. Maybe too much chin.
Maybe
I feel
too
like
much eyebrow.
Too much chin.
They're all like.
Yeah, all of their eyebrows are like permanently pissed off. Like.
Yeah.
This is me watching, starring in Kingdom.
Yeah, literally, they're all like.
Jacki, that's so good. No, that was exactly it.
I think I kind of nailed that. But.
Yeah, you did.
I did not know this anime. I will admit, this is all very intriguing looking to me.
You like, say that every time we watch a trailer for Kingdom, by the way.
Really?
Yes, every time we watch
a trailer for
Kingdom, Jacki's
like,
this looks really intriguing. This looks really interesting. What's this about? And
it does look. It does look good. I keep wanting to see it, but bear in mind that I think longer than Hunter x Hunter at this point.
Oh my gosh, you're kidding me then. No.
Yeah, it's
not happening.
Yeah, and you gotta get, like, people in chat are saying, you gotta get through the first season, which was all, like, kind of ugly CG animated before you can get to, they switched.
But I mean, if it's gotten five seasons looking like that and hasn't like dropped off in quality or anything, it's probably a really good show.
Yeah, the manga was a really big seller. So I think like probably in Japan, maybe it's doing pretty dang well over there because it's got an established audience. I don't think the manga really made it over here. I'm speaking out of my ass, guys. Correct me if I'm wrong. It's just like, I think there's a lot of volumes of manga at this point too. Like,
My brain always mixes it up when I hear about it because I don't think about it between these trailer watch parties, if I'm being perfectly honest.
Yeah.
And whenever I hear about it, my brain, the first place my brain goes is the Netflix K-drama.
Yeah.
Which is a kingdom, which is about the Korean, like 16th, 15th century Korean
aristocracy show, right?
Dealing with a zombie.
Yeah, it's a historical show of zombies.
It's like a historical, like Regency drama type thing, mm-hmm. where you know there's like backstabbing and political intrigue and like people going for the throne, but a zombie apocalypse is happening at the same time.
This one has no zombies, but it might have all the other stuff Geoff just mentioned, just based on, you know, like what it's supposed to be about.
But by the way, just so I don't lose my mind and sound like a total idiot, Noragami was the show I was thinking of.
Oh, okay. No, I haven't seen Noragami either. I heard it's really good.
Noragami's good. Yeah. I've only seen like the first 5 to 10 episodes, but it was fun. And the OPs just slap. They all slap.
Whole thing is
all right. This next one is the second season of a decently popular show. Marshall.
People really like it. I just never got into this one.
Yeah.
No, the anime is a letdown compared to the manga.
Really?
That's the thing with comedy, right? Is if the comedy doesn't translate, then.
Yeah.
Yeah, the animation qualities, as you can see, kind of meh.
A lot of I watched enough of the first season to be like, oh, okay, this is sort of rudimentary looking.
I do like hearing the voices for the new characters they're introducing. Yeah. That's neat, but like...
At number 16, Daxlin called it One Punch Potter, and I think that's probably a...
Yeah, that's basically what it is.
Yeah.
It's funny. Yeah, the production values are just not selling it.
Yeah, I mean, they have fun character designs, and the gimmick is funny, but...
Yeah. I feel like Crunchyroll really wanted this one to take off, and it just didn't.
Yeah.
They were, like, really pushing for this one.
It just doesn't have the like sakuga chops that it needs to sell the central gag, right? Because like,
right? I mean, well, that's what made One Punch Man season one so effective is
it's
you actually
it's
believe in his One Punch Man. It's like, oh yeah,
yeah.
Sounds good. I can barely hear it, but it was good. That's what I was. That was what I was doing that entire time.
We were
time.
Like,
just over here, kind of wiggling to myself. Yeah. So that's Marshall season two. This next one, I've actually read some of the manga to this. Back when Crunchyroll had manga. Do you guys remember when Crunchyroll had manga for a while? This was one of the series that they had. It was called Tale of Wedding Rings. And, you know, it's about a guy who goes to another world to follow the girl that he fell in love with. Only it turns out that she's like an elf princess. And he gets engaged to a bunch of fantasy princesses, you know. Happens. Animation kind of looks like butt. Here we go.
Is that just the running theme of the night?
There's a lot of stuff looking like butt this tonight, you guys.
I mean, every anime studio went super hard last season.
Yeah.
So it like makes sense if the production is a little lacking for a lot of
I can't remember who said it, but last time we had a trailer watch party, someone suggested we just take at least a season, maybe a year, and just. No new anime.
That sounds like something I would say, but it could have also been something you said, James. It kind of sounds like either one of us. Like,
the animation doesn't look great, but like the background art and compositing in this isn't bad at all. Like
they keep putting this white light over kind of everything.
Yeah, I did notice that.
I mean, that I think that's just in a few of the shots. It is kind of like giving Xbox 360 Bloom a little bit.
I'm currently replaying through the whole Gears of War trilogy, and that is a very true and apt statement.
There's some baddies in this one, though, clearly.
Yeah. I like a lot of the characters, like how they look, really cool.
And like a lot of the distant action shots where they, you know, it's just like effects in the backgrounds look really nice.
I'm going to strongly disagree. I thought all that looked kind of like butt.
I kind of like the girl characters, but not.
I don't even feel like they were as well actualized as maybe they could have been. It just had a little more under the hood going on. But that's Tales of Wedding Rings.
Potential.
Is it like a harem thing? Is that why?
I remember from the manga is it's kind of a harem thing.
Okay, so that'll probably be some good trash.
Yeah, this next one, third entry in a popular series that I haven't watched, but probably should. Hey, it's Blue Exorcist! Despair!
Nah, you don't have to watch more of that.
Okay, yeah, Blue Exorcist, like, was so good in the beginning and ended terribly.
Well, I'm gonna disagree
and it didn't really work. So, the problem with the first season of Blue Exorcist is they gave it an FMAO3 ending.
Oh, okay.
Where they ran out of manga, so they just kind of, like, wrote something different.
Okay.
And then when they got another season later, they had to undo the...
They just ignore
it.
And
the retcon
it? Yeah,
they just ignore
it.
They just don't even address it.
Yeah, they pretended. And it sucked ass, right? Like, they tried to condense... it's like two episodes, maybe three. They tried to condense, like, the entire ending of the story into two or three original episodes of content.
Yeah,
it was bad.
But season two is really good. I'm looking forward to this.
It good? I couldn't get into it because I just felt the start of it was jarring.
It was. I had to like.
I remember really liking the beginning of season one. Like, I thought it was a really fun anime, and then season two or the end of it, obviously meh. So then I just gave it up.
Yeah.
But
they're scary looking.
Cool world. I like the characters. You know.
Animation looks really nice.
It does.
Fill me in on the dude with the like trash man goatee.
That's Mephisto. He's the principal of their exorcists.
I would be into that guy. That tracks.
Right, he's a little stinker. So.
Is he a little stinker?
Yeah.
A little stinker. So yeah, this Blue Exorcist, Shimane Illuminati Saga is what they're calling that one. So, okay.
Season two was a lot smaller. It was very much like a kind of a self-contained sort of isolated story. But I granted, it's been however many years, like 3-4 years. But I remember really liking it.
I just fell off it because I felt lost when I got back into it.
Yeah.
Well, so to prepare for reviewing it, I did like watch the first 14 or whatever episodes of season one right before, so that helped. Yeah, but if you tried to get into it when it aired like years after the first season did, yeah, you would have been completely lost.
Yeah,
that was my experience with it. Maybe I'll give it another shot sometime. I do remember really liking it, like the first season until I didn't.
You know. This next one is also shoujo, and I'm interested. I don't know how good it looks, but I hope they pull it off. The main conceit of it is that the main character, she's deaf. So this is called A Sign of Affection.
Oh, I saw this making the rounds on Twitter.
Yuki-chan
ga kaita
no?
The color design is unique. I don't know if I like it or not.
His ridiculously plush lips really threw me off.
Yeah, he's like very
lips are bothering me.
Shoujo manga style for sure.
It almost reminded me of those old 1950s cartoons where they put the live action mouths on top of the still images.
Yeah.
So that's like, this is better.
Yeah.
You think just that one guy? I was like, whoa.
Yeah. Oh, Starkiller says this is Jose. Sorry, I wasn't sure what magazine it ran in.
Okay.
I mean, all the characters look pretty cute.
Very cute.
Even, like,
I like the style of, I mean, when we see them, the style of the background is really appealing.
It's hard to say about the story without any subtitles or anything.
I love that guy's voice. The silver-haired guy's voice. I don't know if you heard it, the voice
actor. You see that? Really nice. Some of those shots where it, like, zooms in on his lips almost looks like a joke. Like a comedy, like sometimes
it's distracting to you.
Like a Cromartie High School, like zooming, you know.
Now they design them like that so they can kiss real good. But like that bar set and that background there.
Yeah.
It, there's some really nice shots in that.
Yeah, I agree. I'm gonna write that one down because I will definitely try it. That's a sign of affection. Okay. That looks cute, and if you know there's enough little drama romance stuff going on, it might hold my interest. This next one is a fantasy series called The Strongest Tanks Labyrinth Raids.
The Strongest Tanks Labyrinth
Raids. You can tell he's a tank because he's got a giant shield.
Oh,
also
boy.
His name is Rud. R-U-D.
Okay. Right. Okay, so as you can see, this is the same character design as that other character design I was talking about.
Yeah, he's got the McDonald's hair.
The gotta have like the mid-bang. The mid-bang has become like a meta thing, I think, since Kirito.
They all got it.
Yeah, mid-bangs are just like...
Quick, wait.
The light novel thing.
Am I an anime protagonist now?
Mm-hmm.
Yes, I see it.
Acknowledge me.
Yeah. He's like, give me attention! Too bad on my head. Their characters are really cute.
Yeah. That's about I've just seen so many magic explosions and stuff already. It's just sort of,
all blends together.
Yeah.
You go in one ear and out the other.
I know for a fact that, like, my husband has made characters in Dark Souls and stuff like that, or it was a Dark or a Souls like that was just wielding two shields. So.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, the great shield builds are really good, actually.
There's an idea. Instead of basing all of these worlds off of, like, super generic, no one ever actually played them in real life RPGs, we need some isekais where they just wind up in Bloodborne.
Bloodborne
in a Souls-like.
Yeah, yeah.
Have you checked out Shangri-La Frontier yet?
I liked it. I did like it. That was good.
Shangri-La Frontier, it doesn't have the Bloodborne or Dark Souls vibe.
It's got a
but like the gameplay is very
And that's what I liked about it, actually. Like, you put some thought like, oh, what kind of game would people maybe play?
Mm-hmm. I don't know if you get deeper into it, but like there's some really cool virtual games.
Sorry, anyway, I'm rude. Sorry.
This next one here is Mr. Villain's Day Off. And I'm kind of curious about this one.
It's a cute title.
Yeah. That's Mr. Villain. It's his day off from being a villain.
Panda!
I don't know why I just screamed that, but... Oh my gosh, panda!
You can take pictures of the pandas?
Panda donuts?
Panda donut! So he has a panda obsession.
Apparently he's into pandas. That's what I'm gaining.
You know what? He doesn't seem that villainous to me.
Yeah. So
well, it's his day off. He's not.
Yeah, he's not doing villain stuff. He's just doing very panda stuff.
He's practicing self-care right now.
Yeah, yeah. I think
self-care is
pandas. I love that for him. I love this for him.
Are there any other characters in this show?
Since it's focusing on all the pandas, as far as the plot goes, a certain man is, in his working life, a major leader in an alien organization bent on...
Oh, he's a Sentai villain? Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Known as the Evil League. But even bad guys need a chance to rest, and on his days off, he does that, trying new ice cream flavors, geeking out over pandas, and awkwardly helping human children and his chief rival, the Red Ranger Dawn. Yeah.
I thought he was a demon lord.
This kind of looks hilarious.
Absolutely.
What's this one called? I'm writing it down.
Mr. Villain's Day Off.
I think this looks funny.
Mr. Villain's Day Off. Yeah, this looks.
Yeah, this looks cute.
Definitely got potential.
Yeah.
Now, it would be funnier if he was like a rubber suit guy, but still.
Yeah. It's reminding me a little bit of
also
World something domination, the one that had a Sentai and a, mm-hmm. a Sentai
Oh,
Ranger.
Love Before World Domination.
Yeah, yeah. Kinda like same
thing. What was the one where it was like the scientists that make the monsters for the Sentai?
Oh, world? I remember that show, but I don't remember the title.
That's really good.
I'm not sure where Mr. Villain's Day Off is streaming. I didn't write it down this time, but probably Crunchyroll. Mr. Villain's Day Off. Okay, I've written that one down. Yeah, that looked cute. You know, nothing spectacular, but looked like a good time.
Usually anime that make fun of Sentai tropes, I don't know, they just tend to hit.
It's yeah.
Like, Love After World Domination, Astro Fighter Sunred.
Yeah.
Samurai
Flamenco. Ms. Kuro, the Monster Development Department, is the one that
yeah.
Think of. Yeah.
Thank you. Right. Was really good. There was that Kamen Rider spinoff last year, I think.
Jacki, stop it. Next. It was the Kamen Rider one last year was... had like W in the title or something, I think. I don't know. It had two dudes who mm-hmm. kind of like merged together, but I can't remember what it's called. But I know where your head's at, Geoff. Yeah. I just can't remember right off the top of my head. The chat, I'm sure, will pipe up here in a second. Futo PI. That was it. Okay.
Futo PI, right?
Yeah. Yeah. All right. Number 29 is a villainess. Jacki, I'm going to assign this to you to review.
No! Oh my god! Oh
there
no.
you go. There you go.
I'm in trouble! Like my next time.
This is seventh time loop. The villainess enjoys a carefree life. So...
Okay, this actually looks really good. It's beautiful.
Yeah, that's
her
some,
hair
that's
is, I don't know if I'm down with what's going on with the hair glow, but...
Yeah, the hair is interesting. It's like shiny.
Yeah, it's not shiny.
I kind of like
is
it.
Is this background
like
music?
Is
the background music Sakura Nagashi from Ava 3.0?
He
maybe
is cute. He's very cute.
Oh, but is he maybe a little bit evil?
Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh, we can fix him, Lynzee.
We can fix him, Jacki!
We can fix him. With our garden matcha tea, we can fix him.
Well, she also had like a bloody machete and was like lockpicking doors with her hairpins. So.
Yeah, I'll read the summary after we get through this to see if it sheds a little more light
flowers.
On
the flowers. I kind of love this.
Yeah.
No, visually this is it's really good.
Yeah.
I think only the hair is weird. Everything else is pretty normal.
Oh,
she looks like
Ooh, he's got a cool scar, Jacki.
That was a really nice scar.
He had like someone tried to hack his head off.
She looks like the girl from that one rom-com that was really disappointing for everybody.
I know exactly.
You're gonna have to be more specific.
The cool girlfriend.
Yes, I know exactly what you're talking about.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, the tall like girl one. Yeah.
Mm. Yeah.
Shikamori. Yeah.
Shikamori.
Yes. Yes. She was stunning. She's one of the prettiest anime girls I've ever seen. I did her hear it wasn't that good, though, so.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's just kind of.
Shikamori. It was definitely Shikamori, yeah.
Yeah.
The dress is horrifying. I like the dress.
I really like some of the subtle stuff they did with the color there. Like, mm-hmm. I've seen a lot of shows try to make the character's hair look airbrushed and it just looks bad, but
choices
like,
were being made on purpose, which is always a good sign.
It's a, like they do a really good job of blending the relatively simple character designs with the extremely complex art. It's just I like the visuals in that one a lot.
So people in chat are asking, the title of this one is Seventh Time Loop, the villainess enjoys a carefree life, and the summary of it, from what we couldn't really glean from the trailer. The main character's name is, I believe it's pronounced Rishe, R-I-S-H-E, Rishi or Rishe. Can't catch a break. After being spurned by her fiance, she fled her home country to make a new life for herself six times. In each case, she chose a different path to happiness, only to die at the age of 20, 5 years after setting out. And each time she reawakened at the moment of being dumped. She's about to start her seventh loop, and this time she thinks she's got it figured out. Each death was somehow related to a war started by Emperor Arnold. Okay. This okay. time,
Arnold is the hot guy.
No, no, no. I think what's Arnold was the blonde emperor that we I think saw in there.
Oh, okay. What's the hot guy's name?
It's not in here, but I'm pretty sure he's supposed to be her fiance. This time, the plan is to stop the war before it starts. And when Arnold himself, nope, never mind. I think the hot guy's name's Arnold. And when Arnold himself proposes to her the night of her escape, that seems like as good a way to do it as any. So unfortunately, his name's Arnold. I'm sorry. Someone please tell them. It's like how they keep naming fantasy characters Keith. Stop naming them Keith in anime, guys. It's Keith.
Keith is
not
a terrible name. I'm sorry to the Keiths out there, but
I'm deeply sorry to anyone.
I know. I'm sorry. That was Keith. Really. That came off so wrong. I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry.
It's not a good fantasy protagonist name. Yeah.
It's not intimidating or badass. It's just
like him. It's like if an isekai hero was named like Carl.
I was literally about to say Carl.
Carl. Exactly. Yeah. Carl Jr.
Unless it was literally Carl from Aqua Teen Hunger Force, then it would be a perfect isekai.
Oh my god, Isekai Carl, him. The neighbor?
Yeah.
Carl? The neighbor of who?
An Aqua Teen Hunger Force.
Oh, yeah.
He would be a good isekai protagonist.
I don't know what's going on here, but it's some
kind of fucking Richard dragon I gotta fight, all right.
Richard's a fine name. It's a sturdy name, Richard. I guess, you know, if you guys get bored during the trailers, you can also put your names in chat and I will rate you. I have a lot of opinions about names. I've named two children, so I've got lots of thoughts on that.
You have good names.
She will be honest. So do this.
I will be absolutely honest with you. Yeah. And I mean, a lot of this comes from a place of being named Lynzee spelled funny. Like my mom set me up with that. Okay. So I've done a lot of introspection.
I love the way your name's spelled though.
Thank you. I get compliments on it all the time whenever I go out, which is strange because people tend to like be like, oh, you've got a creative name. Like I didn't pick it. Okay. My mom just liked how it looked in cursive. It is very, you know, loopy in cursive.
Yeah.
Anyway, so this is a big trailer. I know a lot of people are looking forward to this show in particular. This is Bones' anniversary work called Metallic.
I almost put that down for the title.
Metallic Rouge. You wrote down Bones' anniversary work.
It sounds like an anime title. Look, you show me a show where a pretty anime girl can turn into a badass robot and punch things real hard, then I will show you an interested me. So.
I'm liking what I see.
I like her. She's really cute.
Naomi's I've seen the first episode of this. I got to watch it at Anime NYC.
And?
So the one thing that I will say about it is, like, there is a lot of kind of capital N nouns in the first episode that can be kind of hard to like sort, but give it like another episode.
I like this. I like this scene. The music, that song hit.
Oh yeah, the opening is also like really good.
They came out with a lyric video promotion for this thing. It was like super
really good.
I like how they're like, we can't harm humans, and they literally just say Asimov rule. They don't even bother to.
Yeah. There's drugs, there's
the music,
politics, there's action, there's tokusatsu flavor. They brought in some guys who got some big experience in the tokusatsu scene to design the robots for this. The robot power that you're seeing here. Like
Evangelion Kamen Riders, and it's perfect.
There's aliens as well. And Rouge really likes chocolate, so she's usually eating it.
The only problem I've had with any of the preview material is that the color grading just looks a little dark, a little washed out.
That'll look real good on a 4K TV, though.
Yeah. Yes.
You know, or on an HDR TV.
We'll be on Crunchyroll.
So, I like that one.
Yeah, I'm writing that one down.
Fairy Rose like asks, how old is the other girl? So Rouge is like, she's not human. So
spoiler.
It's in the first episode, you guys. Come on. She's not it. She's a neen.
She turns into a robot.
She's a cyborg. Whatever. She's like a biological, she's got like fleshy bits, but she's not a human. She's just squishy on the outside, you know, and then she can put the armor on. Jackie's giving me all kinds of looks. There's no subtext to what I'm saying. I don't know why you're reacting this way.
She's squishy on the inside. I'm just like,
I,
Yeah. All the word choices. Yeah, someone just said fleshy, important bits. Thank you.
I'm trying not to have my brain go there, but like I kept wanting to say, man, I hope so.
Any other words?
I kept coming up with the word biological and it wasn't working correctly. So I was just trying to say, organic. You know. Huh?
Organic is the...
Organic! Thank you.
Yeah.
She's organic.
Endoskeleton surrounded by organic tissue.
My brain does live there. You're right, Liz.
And they have to inject a certain drug into themselves, you know, the neens, the organic cyborgs. But then humans often steal those drugs to get high. So that's like...
Oh, that's not cool.
Yeah, that's something that's going on. Not orgasmic, wolfcraft, organic. We're going on to the next trailer now. I did this to myself. Okay, so yeah,
you really did, Lindsay. You wouldn't stop either. It was like three in a row, and I was like,
fortunately, the next trailer is extremely wholesome. It is the most wholesome, and I'm not being ironic. This is called Fluffy Paradise.
Very fluffy.
I don't know, she just fell and died. Okay, you know, that's how that goes. Probably from overwork.
Oh no, she's dead?
Yeah, but she's going to be reincarnated in another world, Jacki.
Thanks, Jesus.
Oh, it's that town.
As a baby. And everyone's really nice, and she gets to be a little baby.
A little chubby little toddler baby.
She's got little aminal friends.
She gets to be Snow White now, basically.
Well, that's nice.
Man, she really like lost in the God that reincarnates you lottery, though. That's the most boring reincarnated
I've
seen in any of these.
Surprisingly, call it animation.
Especially for all the animals.
Yeah, it looks really cute.
So for those of you watching this, please don't imitate what you're seeing on screen at your local zoo. Okay?
That's so cute.
Are those Velociraptors?
Was there a dinosaur? Did I miss that?
Or dragons, I'm assuming. There must be dragons.
So there's a giant spider.
Precious,
that's, you know.
Won't watch this. It looks very cute.
Yeah.
As anime about people who work themselves to death and then get to have like a chill, fluffy time doing video game stuff in another world go, that looks at least in the top 50% of the 40 or so of those that exist.
I mean, admittedly, one of the top things I would want to do if I lived in a fantasy world is just be around
all the fluffy animals. Critters.
Pet all the animals. Yeah.
Yeah.
It looks like
well, Hagrid's job. I'd want Hagrid's job.
I call that subgenre Karoshi Sakai.
Okay, I can't. Now you're taking this place.
Yeah, I understand that pun, and I shake
James
my head.
James is like, I draw the line here.
I tried.
I'm sorry, that was hilarious.
I tried. That was
where are we at, Lindsay? What number are we at?
What number
are
we at?
32.
We are at, 32. So we're kind of in the home stretch here. This is a sequel to a kind of rom-com that I think people like. I didn't watch it. Sorry, but this is Dangers in My Heart Season 2.
This was good. This one was really good.
It's about the boy who thought he was kind of like the edgy loner.
And then I didn't finish it. But
The show was cute. I liked it. I mean, it's no Teasing Master Takaki, so I'm one of the greatest rom-coms of all time. But it is cute.
Just has two moles on her neck that look like a vampire bite.
She's a model.
So
she's like a part-time model. And
I also loved her because she was a tall girl.
But Jacki, you know that means that she's like 5'5". Right?
Exactly. Not 6'2", but you know, whatever.
Jacki, a good show you would like to throw on in the background that's a rom-com about a tall girl is Lovely Complex.
Did you send me that one too?
Probably.
Yeah.
But yeah, this one's pretty adorable. It's like
He's not as much of a creep as the first episode might make you worry that he is.
Yeah.
He's just really awkward and weird. And again, I get that Japan doesn't have the don't come to school tomorrow issues that we have. So it's also very much a... It didn't play that way to the target audience.
I remember that being something based on, like, the synopsis on the back of the manga slash first episode where he was given those kind of vibes. But I think that
quickly... Well, in the first episode, he like straight talks about like he fantasizes about being a serial killer that kills his classmates. But it's like he's in an edgy middle schooler way where he's been like, that's it.
I'll... And then he realizes that she's just as big of a dork as he is.
Oh, okay. Because
He doesn't live in a country where that's actually incredibly feasible and a regular occurrence.
Like the idea of a teenage kid in killing his classmates in Japan is still pretty much ridiculous, I think.
Yeah.
So it's like it's something they can.
It doesn't have the baggage. Yeah.
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 Well, I mean, they're still at the point where when it does happen, it's like national
it's
news.
It's shocking.
The whole
national
country shuts
news.
Down. Yeah. You know, shows get canceled and lost.
Yeah, I remember school days. Yeah.
Nice boat.
Yeah. Okay, so this next one, at first, we're going to start watching it, and you guys are going to be like, Lynzee, what's this? Why is this here? But I promise it belongs. Okay, this is going to stream on Hulu, specifically. And
I'm sorry, Geoff. That means you don't get to see it, probably.
Or Disney Plus, depending on where you're at, Hulu or Disney Plus. And this is Dragons of Wonder Hatch.
Although, Geoff, you guys did get Undead Unluck finally, right?
Yeah, we did, eventually.
Thank God, that show rules.
It is really good.
Is it like a Peach Dragon thing?
I'm halfway through Undead Unluck. It was solid. Haven't finished it yet, though.
I'm not sure where that puts you in regards to the twists, but man, that show has
I don't think I've seen a twist yet.
Oh, there's
good very
ones.
Cute. I really like the duo.
I'm deep in the manga on that one.
See, I told you there's anime in this. Oh,
okay, so it's like half anime,
it's
half
Page live Master.
It's, yeah.
There we go. It's reverse.
Oh my god,
Page Master,
James, my heart. Oh.
So it's an isekai, but with the isekai world being anime. I kind of like that.
Yeah.
You know what? This freaking rules. Okay.
Yeah, this is fun.
Oh, yeah.
I'm hyped for this. When it comes out in Canada, I'll be excited to watch it.
The live action actors are also very good looking.
Yeah, they're beautiful.
Like the costumes and stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Totally. And the hair.
Oh, it's gonna be so exciting when she inevitably ends up in the anime world, and we get to see. Oh, this is gonna be great.
Yeah.
I'm like,
ooh.
On the effects are good. Yeah.
The only reason, like.
Is this a mini series? Is this like a full season? Do we know how long this is going to be?
I don't know how many episodes it is off the top of my head.
This looks very good. Oh, that's Zoro, right? Was that Zoro right there?
Oh, the actor that played. Are you saying Mockingjou? I'm not sure Mockingjou is in this.
Maybe not, but
look at that little dragon guy.
No, the CG dragon's really cute. Oh, man. Emotions are going to start getting intense. This is a 2.5 minute trailer, by the way. It's kind of long.
Dude, he's such a cutie.
Yeah.
God, I regret not putting this on my most anticipated list because this is like 100%.
Probably a little obscure until this moment. I don't know how much promotional stuff there was ahead of time.
I'm sorry. Hulu promoting their anime? Come on, Lynzee. It's not. Let's be real.
This is not going to happen. The only thing that like concerns me about it is we haven't seen a lot of the anime parts. It seems to mostly be like live action.
Oh, I bet it'll be like 80-20 live action animation.
Yeah, so I don't know if like as an anime specifically, that's like my most hype anime, but like I do wish they were Roger Rabbiting it. I do wish that they did that. I don't know if it would necessarily.
I don't know,
but
Geoff,
better.
you know what Zemeckis had to put those animators through to make that look good.
Yeah.
I feel like if they tried to Roger Rabbit it under the constraints of like Japanese animation production schedule, it would actually probably look not good. That'd be my worry.
There was a message in chat, but I missed it. Someone said that this is actually you can go watch it now. Like, it just came out in the last week, I think.
Oh, I'm going to watch this
tonight. If you like this, search Dragons of Wonder Hatch.
So is it like a dump? Is it or is it just the first
episode? I don't have the details of it up, but they said there's several episodes available now. So maybe it was a dump in like something like 8 episodes, something like that.
Okay.
Oh, yeah. It's on
pretty impressive.
They also say it's on Disney Plus in the US. So maybe.
Oh, nice.
Yeah. Four episodes are out now.
Okay. Maybe as in, I'll check that out.
No. Yeah. I'm gonna write it down. I agree with Geoff's point that it may not be truly very animated, but like all of the live action stuff looked really good too.
Yeah, it looks like a really good drama.
Yeah.
With some animated elements.
Yes.
Which I'm not gonna complain about that.
The little baby dragon gave me baby Gamera vibes from like the most recent live action Gamera movie when he's a little baby.
Yeah.
Sorry, that just made me really happy.
By the way, Lynzee, we're still live on Instagram.
Are we really? Oh, yeah. I'm glad that we managed to stay up past an hour. StreamYard warned me that we may not. So, hey, Insta fans. I don't think it's showing any of your guys' comments.
There was 2 people in there, but...
That explains some things. Yeah.
But, most people YouTube and Twitch right now, so...
Yeah, that makes sense, yeah.
Hey, it looks like it's up in Europe, so it might actually have a global rollout this
time. I'm going to watch that tonight. I thought that looked super cute. So it's out every week, I'm assuming?
The 4 episodes, maybe all of them.
That might just be the whole thing.
Yeah. Oh, you know what? No, episode 5 comes out on January 3rd. There's going to be 6 episodes total, 4 available now, 2 more left to premiere. Hmm. So,
Interesting.
So you can catch up right after the stream.
What are we at, 35 now?
We're at 34. 34.
All right, here we go. 10 this, more?
This one I thought might be cute. We'll have to see. It looks sort of like a rom-com or harem with... The Foolish Angel Dances with the Devil. So, you know how I gotta be. Okay, no, actually, this already looks kind of mediocre. Dang, guys. I just wanted some hot devil dudes, but I'm getting lots of feline lines. Feline lines everywhere. Why are they boxing? I don't
know. Oh, and she's like a child. She's like a tiny child.
You can't just put sparkles on him and convince me he's hot. That's not how this works. Didn't work for Twilight. Doesn't work now. Why are we watching a boxing scene? I'm so confused.
This is very confusing, yeah.
Oh, did you see that wonderfully animated JPEG of the character being wild?
Yeah. There's some weird stuff going on with their hair, too.
What is happening here?
Someone had a little bit of whiskey or something.
No, that's a bad touch.
I don't know what the hell is happening right now, but it's barely happening.
Oh, this looks not good.
Yeah. I am deeply disappointed that a devil guy was wasted on this, though.
I mean, some of the shots don't look that bad, but it looks like a completely different anime every single time.
Yeah, I have no idea what's going on. There's like so much. I'm like,
why was there boxing? I'm still mad. Why was there boxing? Stupid Angel Dances with the Devil. So
stupid. Just kidding.
Stupid. just stupid. I'm seeing Kadokawa on a lot of these, and I just want to tell my overlords, pick better stuff, please.
Or maybe make slightly less stuff so that it can be of higher quality.
Yes. Yeah. Everyone's like, where's the angel? And I was like, I don't know. He's the angel. I thought he was the devil. Anyway, no one's watching that. This next one is the second season or second half of, this is also Hulu. At least I'm pretty sure the first season was on Hulu. Nick Dupree actually said it's pretty good. Sinduality Noir.
Oh yeah.
That one.
I got
this is still going, huh?
I didn't realize this is getting a second season.
I mean, the game just dropped, I think. So it's this was a tie-in anime for a game from Namco.
I thought it was Sega, but maybe not.
What is this called?
Sinduality Noir, and the game is just called Sinduality something else. But it's like, post-apocalyptic mecha thing.
Yeah.
And I liked it.
But they're like little chunky mechas. So like,
yeah, yeah.
Yeah. It's a fun little story.
That's kind of a cool shot. He's talking to a giant hologram boy.
But the game is really cool because you like take the mechs out into like an open world and like gather resources and stuff.
I just want to point out there's a guy here with silver hair and double eye patch.
I missed him. I was dancing.
I think he'll come back. He looks like he's kind of important, maybe.
This is a show that I've been meaning to catch up on. I might get around to it sometime.
Yeah, I want to. Oh, did you see that Zoid sticker in the background there? There's like a lot of like little nods to like they got Pac-Man arcade machines and stuff around because it's like Namco supported.
Dude, my kingdom for a good Zoids anime.
I didn't get to see my eye patch, boy. Yeah, I'm good. That looks like knockoff Gundam Witch Mercury. Sorry. No.
Yeah, I mean, didn't watch the first season.
I watched the first like episode or two. It was fun. It's good. Yeah, I would say
it's fun. It's got good characters. It's it's an anime. It's a lot better, I will say, as anime tie-ins to Namco Bandai current games go than Scarlet Nexus was. Like, it's a lot better.
Scarlet Nexus just sort of shit the bed. This next one's got a skeleton in it, and also it's either a fantasy or an isekai. I'm so sorry.
Is it a hot skeleton?
Debatable.
A funny skeleton.
This is the unwanted undead adventurer. That shot looks good. Okay.
Okay. So, yep. Overlord likes are officially a genre now.
He's a sentient skeleton man.
There's skeleton knight.
Yeah. I will say that while a lot of these trailers have been disappointing, I'm most disappointed about the lack of bops. We have not heard like any really good theme songs this entire stream. What is going on over there?
They used up all the good music that the industry had last season. That's it. It's just we're all out of good music.
I've been waiting for Queen Bee to show up again, and
I do like this part of the OST.
Yeah, that song was okay. I mean, this looks more competent than a lot of the things we've seen. Yeah, it is trying.
It's meh to me.
E for effort, I guess.
I think it's got potential, but I didn't get anything from that trailer.
Yeah, I didn't. Yeah, we also haven't had anything like completely bonkers. Like, remember the trailer we watched last party where things just kept randomly happening? We didn't end up watching the show, but it was like, I don't know, someone had a gun and then there was an airplane and then it crashed and then there was just,
oh my God.
It was just like a salad where they kept adding things to it. Like, yeah, what is going on? That was at least interesting.
James, what's the gorilla one?
Fruit of Evolution.
Yes.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Why would you
that trailer? I legit again? Was like, this is nonsense.
Fruit of Evolution. Oh man,
Fruit we're of not Evolution talking about the Donkey Girlfriend again. It's not happening.
We're not talking.
Not talking about Donkey Girlfriend. Not talking about Abraham Lincoln. No.
Hey, that's like probably the most fun I've ever had writing reviews for a show that I hated. So I'll at least give it that.
Yeah.
If you enjoyed hating on that, you should definitely check out. I got a cheat skill in another world and became unraveled in this one too, because it's from the same author as Gorilla, and it's after about half of the scenes in that show where the protagonist does something and saves the day, either in the alternate world, but usually in the main world where he used to be like a fat bullied kid, and he leveled up and got really buff and everything.
Oh, so yes, that happened in both of his stories.
Yeah, that happens in both of his stories, yes. Okay. Although, in this one, it does not imply that fat people are literally subhuman.
A different species of people.
Which is what Gorilla does. But it's what's funny about that one is, like, literally every time he, like, accomplishes anything, everybody around him in the real world just pauses and claps. Literally everybody clapped.
Is it a gag or is it sincere?
No, it's sincere. There's this part where he goes to the mall to get some new clothes because he's hot now, so he needs clothes. And while he's at the mall because he's hot, he gets recruited by this photo shoot that's doing a model photo shoot at the mall. And the hot model didn't show up, but then he shows up later and he's like, "You're not hot enough to be in this. Excuse me, I'm going to go hit on my female co-star." And he's like, "Hey, man, that makes her uncomfortable. You shouldn't do that. Well, I'm going to punch you in the face now." And then he tries to, but he trips. And literally everybody in the entire mall, three stories of mall, all looking in on this in the middle of the mall, they're all like, "He's so cool!
See, Lynzee, we should know better than to think that the author of this could write a joke.
No, definitely.
It's been made perfectly clear that he does not understand what a joke is.
Definitely. this next one got is High Card Season 2.
I never watched High Card.
AJ liked it. So he reviewed it for us last season, and
it seemed like it could be kind of
superpowers with. I mean, aren't all the character designs by Clamp, or did I imagine that?
I'm really glad this is getting another season. This was solid.
Oh yeah, god, they blew up Versailles. Never mind, it's not Versailles, but
we definitely watched this.
I got super hyped for it.
Yeah, I remember. I thought it looked really good. Now I'm like, should I watch it?
You should. The first season's really good. It's like a rare original anime, you know? Action scenes slap. It's got really creative powers.
I love the characters. I'm going to watch this after I watch Wonder Hatch, or maybe I'll see which one catches my fancy more.
Sure.
I mean, after Hunter x Hunter, right?
I do like the character designs a lot. After Hunter x Hunter
and Undead Unluck. This looks very good to me. Yeah.
Yeah. No. This. It's super sick. It's got cool, like modern
setting based on
it's just. It's so good.
Yeah. I mean, honestly, for this season, I've probably written down 5. Like, I would definitely watch this.
Did we not all see his throbbing wounds? Am I allowed to say throbbing? Am I allowed to say
the word choice?
Lynzee, you're allowed to say anything that you want.
Pulsating might have been
the open wounds,
but they were like Geoff said, they were doing this. What do you call this, Jacki? Pulsating or throbbing. That's what the word means. Whoa.
Chad. Lindsay's gonna get us kicked off YouTube and like
sorry. Kind of. Dang, that I don't know, that night kind of sold me there kind of at the end.
I think the animation looked amazing. I liked the world. I remember last time I loved the two guys, the guy in the yellow suit. I forgot the other guy, but I'm like, I don't know how I missed that one. When did that come? When was season one out?
That was winter, last winter, but you were probably too caught up on Buddy Daddies to check it out.
Oh yeah, we were Buddy Daddies. Yeah. What else went on then? There was a couple that season. That was a good season.
Were we also watching G-Witch? I think we're watching G-Witch.
Yeah. Yeah, G-Witch was then, I think. Yeah.
People are suggesting that I should have said Doki Doki, which is fair. His wounds were Doki Doki.
They were Doki Doki.
They were Doki Doki wounds, yeah.
Next!
You guys tired of me yet? Okay, this next one comes from a big franchise. Just got a remake on Netflix, and now they're continuing it.
One Piece?
This new season is coming. It takes place 14 years after the original.
Oh, the Shaman King.
Shaman King Flowers.
Wait, so is this a sequel to the original full Shaman King story?
Yeah, it takes place 14 years after the original Shaman King story.
Oh, okay.
Seventh
grade me would have been super stoked about this. Because I was really into Shaman King for like a hot minute.
Yeah.
That must be Yo and Anna's kid. That's oh.
The guy had an eye patch, Jacki. Did you see it?
He did.
I just hope it's better than the Shaman King second adaptation.
Yeah, I heard the Netflix one was not that great. Everyone's so kind of super deformed proportions in this, is what I'm noticing too.
That's just more accurate to Hiroyuki Takei's style.
She's cute.
They are actually doing like a really good job of adapting his style this time around compared to other
Does it say flowers of corn, as in maize, as in corn?
Yep.
Okay. I mean, this looks good. I'm not really like in on the Shaman King train, but visually, I thought that looked pretty good.
Yeah.
Yeah. It was fine.
I'm only the only reason I'm skeptical is because the last one was mid. But,
yeah. Yeah, that's fair.
Do we? I mean, do we know? Is it the same crew, like the same production
team? Oh, I'm sure the encyclopedia page on ANN would definitely know that. But yeah, I don't know if it's the same studio director. Storyboard artist sort of crew working on this one. But that'd be something to look into if you thought that looked good, but we're disappointed with the Netflix adaptation. Mm-hmm. Okay. This next one has the silliest title of anything I think we've watched so far. This is a BL anime that's getting a full TV series, which is not quite as common. It's become a little more common recently. And for everyone making fun of my phrasing, this one is not my fault. This is Cherry Magic. 30 years of virginity can make you a wizard? Oh no, I was hoping for our BL fans to actually look.
Lynzee, you can't just drop that in and say that warning. That's not fair.
That's the name of it.
Truly, Lynzee, I'm like, what?
There's also a live action version that I think is streaming on like Netflix or something if you'd like to watch this with real actors instead. But we got an office worker guy here. He's a virgin and he's 30, and now he's got wizard powers that lets him read his co-worker's mind, and that's how he finds out that he's got the hots for him. That's the premise.
Okay, so he's not gay yet.
He might also be gay. I don't remember. I don't know if this is a, oh, you're just the one, like, same-sex person that I happen to like scenario, or if he's just outright gay, but he's kind of a shy guy and doesn't really know, didn't know that his co-worker had those feelings for him, and obviously, you know, things kind of kick off.
Lots of people in chat are like, where's my magic powers?
Yeah. Okay.
Okay. Chat, that is hilarious.
Yeah.
Can I just say,
all the touched elbows.
Anime makes me imagine that dating in Japan must be so goddamn difficult.
Yeah. He dropped his water. What's happening? What's happening? Are they going to kiss in their business suits?
Yeah, they are. Right up against the precarious guardrail.
Why do they keep showing this girl? Okay, never mind.
Doing a ghost pottery scene, but doing with like Photoshop or an Excel spreadsheet or something.
That is hilarious, Jeff. That was hilarious.
Whoopi Goldberg comes in and just asks if they have the reports done yet for the weekly.
That was actually hilarious, Jeff. That was a good joke. Looks interesting. You know, I like that it's not like tonight we've seen so much of the same thing. I like that was different.
Yeah.
What was that one called?
You want Cherry me to repeat
magic.
The title?
Cherry Magic, no, 30 years no. of virginity can make you a wizard.
Yeah. Thank James you. Has got it.
James memorized it.
Yeah.
I'm never forgetting that title. Are you kidding me?
I think I have like 10 right now.
I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I have 6.
Yeah, I have 10 that I think are like okay. I'm like not like I high card I really liked.
Sating Wizard Boys. You heard it here first.
Better title.
The Bucchigiri looked really good.
That was probably one of the best ones that we've definitely
Bucchigiri. Is that it?
No, we've got 4 more.
Okay, because I've only got like 4 on my list so far.
Yeah,
this is a week.
This was gonna happen. Like,
hold on, Solo Leveling is this season, right?
Yeah.
Okay, that's gonna be number 1. I got to see the first 2 episodes. It's fucking brilliant.
Okay.
No, what's filling out my 4th, 5th spot?
It's not.
Yeah, I'm like, it's fucking brilliant. Like, you all will. Well, I'll talk about it later after we see the trailer. Sorry, yeah. I shouldn't have said that right now.
Yeah, spoiler. Jacqueline. So this is Sengoku Yoko. Wow, an umbilical cord. You never see that. This is Sengoku Yoko. This is based on a manga by the creator of Lucifer and the Biscuit Hammer, Planet With.
Planet With?
Yeah, so.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Actually good animation in a Mizukami anime? What? Yeah, what?
I know.
What?
I know.
What? What? This looks so good! This is... Okay, never mind. I gotta rewrite my whole list. This is gonna be the best thing this season. It's not even close.
I've read the first volume of the manga because I had to prepare to interview the director at Anime NYC. And it should have some really good action sequences. There's a part where they fight an entire castle.
Hell yeah.
Castle comes to life. Gotta defeat a castle.
Mizukami, the goat. Oh, it's White Fox. That makes so much sense.
Yeah.
Then maybe, finally, after this, Spirit Circle, please?
Yeah. Oh,
please,
I love
Spirit
Circle
look like this. Make Spirit Circle it look like this. I will give you $1,000,000. I don't have it. I will find a way. I will steal it.
So, Jack, he doesn't have an eye patch, but he does have white hair, and he is the main character.
Yeah, he's cute. What was this one called?
Sengoku Yoko. The purple-haired guy and the white-haired fox guy are the same person. He's a human, but he hates humans. And then the girl with the blonde hair is a supernatural being that's lived for like 100 years. So she gives him the powers that lets him transform and then fight. And they also pair up with like this kind of the guy you saw rolling on the ground at the very end there. He's kind of like this kind of worthless dude that ends up teaming up with them. And they add another girl to the entourage as well. But yeah, that's Sengoku Yoko. It looks pretty good.
Yeah.
And
yeah, and I
still need to read Biscuit Hammer because the anime was so bad that I obviously didn't watch it. But after Planet With, I will watch literally anything that man makes.
Yeah.
You gotta read. Just read. You gotta read it.
Yeah, Biscuit Hammer is supposed to be really good. I think the manga's out of print now.
Yeah, and it's
it was on Crunchyroll manga
until Crunchyroll got rid of their manga stuff. It was on there.
Yeah, you used to be able to read it there too. Yeah,
I think you can get it on Bookwalker. I'm not sure.
Oh yeah, possibly. I'd have to look that up.
Yeah, I just got to get a physical set of that one.
Yeah.
And Spirit Circle, for that matter. I read them both digitally back
Yeah,
in the day,
Spirit Circle's really, really good. All right, this next one needs no introduction. You all know what this is.
Yeah.
Oh, Yurusei Yatsura.
There we go.
Yeah.
More Yurusei Yatsura, baby.
So cute.
Good stuff. Yeah.
The show is funny. The dub is funny though too.
Yeah. It's got a good dub?
Yeah, like I thought that it translated with the dub.
And it looks so good.
I love that girl. The one in the like the black unitard and she's got the pink, the second healing girl. I thought she was so funny.
It's really nice to see like a Rumiko Takahashi series given that like premium animation treatment. That's such a cute. Is that a capoche?
It's a cute basket.
Yeah.
Isn't she adorable though?
She is really cute. Yeah.
I have another one, but she's back in that corner. I'm not gonna get her.
You'd have to probably dig her out. Yeah.
But yeah, it's so nice to like, because I've been a fan of Takahashi stuff forever, and like the problem with like all of the anime based on her stuff, you know, like Maison Ikkoku, Inuyasha, and Ranma, it's all like sometimes it's really good and it like really highlights why her character designs work so well, but then a lot of the time it's just stiff and like low grade. So it's so nice just seeing her work get the like primo treatment.
Yeah, that's David Production, if I remember right. So that's also what they're doing right now instead of JoJo's. So
she's
so funny.
Weirdly miss Fire Force. I don't know why, but for the past like
six months, James, you ragged on that show the entire time you reviewed it, didn't you?
No, I didn't rag on it. There were just a lot of flaws that kept it from reaching its full potential.
Okay.
But as time has gone
sounds like a dad talking to his second child.
A little bit. Well, as time has gone on, now that the nest is empty, I miss having my stupid pervy fire child in my house.
Why are we talking about Fire Force?
Because David Production animated it, and they also animated this new version of.
I haven't heard of Fire Force in like years. I feel like.
Yeah, it's supposed to be getting more, but Yeah.
It fell off. I don't know. Yeah. Someone said Fire Force is very eh. I felt the same way.
Yeah.
Sorry, James. James, you like it.
I'm not saying it's amazing. I'm just saying I want to see more of it.
It's James is trash. James is
trash.
I think over the past few years, I've just realized I would rather have trashy, stupid, and occasionally kind of offensive fun than just boring.
Yeah,
it was such a unique, fun idea, though. I love like that they fought with fire, and I don't know, like it was pretty.
Firefighters were having a moment at that time. Like Fire Force came out around the same time. Well, the anime,
the trigger one. What was
the trigger one, which was Promare, which also came out the same time as Masaaki Yuasa's Ride Your Wave, and the main character of that was also a firefighter.
So how funny!
And there was also some horny like comic festa. Basically porn, but not really thing at the same time that was also about firefighters. So not that I saw it, but it was, you know, at the same time.
Anyways, on a related note, if you want to see a firefighter anime that's actually like
Daigo
about real fire, yeah, Firefighter Daigo, real good. Yeah. Real good.
Yeah.
Is it like the most popular anime in Japan right now?
Is
like
it?
One of them?
I wouldn't be surprised.
I thought I read something where it was getting like insane ratings over in Japan, but over here no one's really watching.
Oh, I didn't know that. Still need someone to review it. The first half. Just putting that out there, everybody. All right. This next one I'm interested in based solely on the title. Don't know if it's going to look good. I guess we'll find out. This is The Witch and the Beast. Crunchyroll has this one.
Love the name.
Mm-hmm.
That's a very stylish static image.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay. I like the world.
The steampunky.
Backgrounds look okay. Okay. Why do people chew on the straws? Is that like a nervous tick?
Yeah.
Okay. Yep. I like
her. Yeah, she's aggressive. That's what that indicates.
Ooh, okay.
Okay, I like the powers.
This is cool. Oh, I love the way she looks.
Someone said Benitis sides, and I agree with this.
The character designs are giving me like vague undead murder farce vibes a little bit.
Okay. Yes, I 100% thought of that, James. Yeah, sorry, I didn't know why I screamed that. But yes.
Okay, but there was a shark. Y'all
the anime with sharks that give that Zom 100 rules.
Oh yeah,
plus 2 points.
I'm on board with this.
This looks. I really like this.
I am writing it down.
Yeah, I'm writing.
What is this one? Oh, the Witch and the Beast. Yeah.
Witch and the Beast. It looks like it has a lot of trash husbands too. So I'm there for that. And she's cool.
Yes, she is.
Yeah, the blonde's really cool.
Yeah.
Yeah. The taller guy.
She's the kind of girl that I would like overhear talking shit about me and my friends in high school, and I would think, you know what? That's fair.
That guy looked cool with the mask, too. We only saw him for a second.
Yeah,
she would be one of those girls I wanted to be friends with.
I don't know if you guys caught that, but that was a different town at the end there. That was not the town. They had a town, and it wasn't the town. That's
two settings. We're getting a little crazy.
Those who want to know a little more about the story, Ashaf is a soft-spoken man with delicate features, a coffin strapped to his back, and an entourage of black crows. Guido or Guido, it's spelled like chateau at the end, so I think it's Guido. A feral, violent girl with long fangs and the eyes of a beast. What's so funny, James?
I'm just thinking.
You're thinking about the character literally named Chateau from that anime.
No, I'm thinking that if her name's Guido, it just makes her sound like a bum from Jersey Shore.
It's Guideo. How do you pronounce that?
That is how I would pronounce that.
Guido, right?
Guido.
Okay. Yeah. With the eyes of a beast, this ominous pair appear one day in a town in thrall to a witch. I'm assuming that was the girl with the long black hair. A ruler with magic coursing through
Guido
her
tattoos. Shot first.
No. Coursing through her tattooed body, who has convinced the townsfolk she's their hero, but Ashaf and Guido know better. They live by one creed. Wherever a witch goes, only curses and disasters follow. They have scores to settle, and they won't hesitate to remove anyone in their way, be it an angry mob or an army garrison.
So. Are we finally going to redeem tattooed badass main characters after Taboo Tattoo ruined it for the last decade?
Was that by the same, like, giant order person?
No, it was just around the same time. Oh, it happened almost at the same time. It was like Big Order, Taboo Tattoo, Handshakers. It was a
Jacki's evolved into her final form because
I know, right? I'm like, it's like I keep on messing with my hair. It was wet. It's starting to finally dry.
Anyway, that one looks that one looked really good, and I don't know if this next one's any better because it's literally about a dude picking up trash. So here's the weakest tamer began a journey to pick up trash. That's the full real title.
I mean, I guess
we've seen so many blob children this tonight, you guys. So many just vague blob children. Oh no. Oh no. I don't want to watch child abuse. What is happening? No.
Oh my gosh. What?
Oh.
Okay.
Is that how she got isekai'd?
Is it?
Murdered as a child?
I don't.
Wow, that was really intense.
Yeah. Animation looks nice already.
Yeah.
A lot of beefy dudes, Jack.
Beefy dudes with scars.
Yeah, what is...
many of them looking older, which, you know, I'm about
to... Who is this for? Is this for me? Was this made for me?
I know. I was like, go back to that silver fox.
Yeah. They can't decide on which... There's too many now. How many are there?
I feel like I love those twins. Like they're gonna be fun.
Jacki, did you like the twins in Oren High School Host Club too?
I didn't watch that show. I feel every clip I've seen of them, I love them though.
Yeah.
This looks pretty good. I wrote this off honestly as soon as I heard the title because you know the adjectivist noun gets something is not a winning anime title.
This
formula.
Is beautiful. Yeah.
But if it is in fact an isekai, we can also officially make it shorthand title Trash Isekai, which would be pretty.
Yeah.
So what is what was that one?
That one is called The Weakest Tamer Began a Journey to Pick Up Trash.
Gosh darn it.
And the main character's name is Ivy. She doesn't remember most of her past life, and she's in an RPG-like world, so it is an isekai.
Trash isekai!
Where she's the weakest class and the weakest rank, a no-star tamer. Her parents don't want anything to do with her, so she has to survive on her own, and she decides to live off the land and salvage what she can from other people's. So she's, like, picking up people's trash to survive. I think it was an
isekai. Literally a trash goblin.
A trash goblin.
Weird right. that she got... That she got leather faced at the very beginning. That's
I'm gonna write that one down. Weakest tamer. Okay, we've got two more. This next one is a ridiculous mecha show called Bang Brave Bang Bravern.
Good.
Yes. Good.
Okay.
Yes. The
side game.
The rule of thumb with mecha stuff: the less sense the English title makes,
That's
funny. Rule of thumb there.
So side games, for those who don't know, it's the same people who are behind Uma Musume
and Rage of Bahamut, which we were talking about earlier. How much that means.
Yeah.
I heard America. Oh, Lewis Smith. He is American.
Oh, I wonder where he's from.
American. Wait. International mech pilots.
Yes.
Given me.
As they're fighting in an empty rock quarry, it really is a tokusatsu.
Yeah, there's two main characters. One of them's American. The other one's Japanese, I think.
I'll be honest, I don't actually like these mech designs very much.
Yeah, but
they're
like
very industrial, right?
But they're industrial, but they, you know, they look super plasticky. And
Bang Brave Bang Bravern.
Is this so that they can pee without like taking the top part
It better
off?
Be. It better
are
be.
Are those Jacki? Tell me those aren't.
What is wrong with Lynzee, y'all?
Nothing's wrong with me. Look at them.
I mean, what else could it be for?
Those are pee pockets.
That was the last thing I was...
Those are just chaps. They're just wearing chaps.
Those are pee pockets, just like the butt pockets they have on long johns.
It's just for maneuverability. I'm the one who's supposed to go there with my brain, Lynzee.
I know. I'm like,
it's not your job.
Call it like I see it, all right? It looks like they're wearing full Teflon armor. Right, not just a vest, it's like pants too. But there's no Teflon covering their junk so that they can pee. All right,
We need a full Dune-style info dump where it explains that they like recycle their waste mid-battle to fuel their robots or whatever.
No, Jackie, this is important, okay? First off, Geoff is arguing this for maneuverability. I have worn a speed suit or jump suit before. It doesn't have that. I can move just fine in it.
That's a speed suit that's designed for movement. You're talking about Teflon armor.
Oh, my God.
And does not...
Explain the stitching, Geoff.
Just trust me, every single guy watching this completely understands why that pocket is there.
Lynzee is a better pocket.
It's for flexibility.
Right. Whatever. First episode, someone's going to just rip it out. All right, next one.
Next. What the hell? Oh, my God.
I broke James. I'm sorry.
You're solo leveling, guys. It's what you've been waiting for. It's the last trailer. Last trailer, solo leveling. Oh, God.
I actually don't know anything about this one.
We're going to go into heavy detail after this.
Oh, God. He died a lot.
Gory. It is intense.
It's based on a Korean comic. And unfortunately, the artist of the comic did pass away last year. Oh, you didn't know. No. I'm sorry.
Oh, that's so sad.
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, is the story finished?
I don't know.
And then not to be insensitive, but one of my first questions would be like, is this even going to be a full?
I don't mind. I like Berserk just fine. I'm not going to write it off because of that. But
yeah. Oh, they got Hero
Yoshiwara
to do the music.
Yes.
There's will be a bop at some point during this trailer, then for sure. Here it comes.
Yep. The drop.
There we go. There we go.
Chat is saying that they did finish the comic before he passed away, but it wasn't.
That's
a lot of time between finishing it and the. Yeah. Finally.
I've heard a lot of good stuff about this manhwa and like.
I can't wait to tell y'all. I'm like, I'm ready to go in a heavy detail.
Yeah, this all looks great. Another scary spider. Let's go. Cerberus. Cool. Ooh. Solo leveling. Okay. I'm expecting this to be the big one of the season.
So, yeah. I think...
That or Don Meshi, I think.
Yeah, not much. Oh, yeah. So, Crunchyroll has put in like all their resources into this one. Like, they want this one to be a biggie, right? Like, they had this like huge LA thing, and it was like super fancy schmancy with like all these photo ops and everything.
Yeah.
And I was like, okay, well, is it actually good, right? The first two episodes were really intense, really gory. And there was like mystery to it. And I really liked like the lore and the world building. And they alluded to some like really incredible characters that like we barely even got like a taste of. And I was honestly blown away. It is like Berserk level goriness and like darkness level. Like, it is heavy. I don't know if it's as good. I love Berserk, right? Like, Berserk is near and dear to my heart. But it kind of shocked me that it was like that intense. You know what I mean? Like, I just didn't know what it was about. I was like, okay, like, if you look at the manhwa at when we were at like Anime NYC, Lynzee, it's like this gorgeous boy.
Yeah.
Like, hold on. It's like this super
Jack, he has a gorgeous boy in the back of the apartment.
It's like this beautiful dude, and you're like, oh, he's pretty, and he has a like dagger, cool. And it was like, I had no idea it was what it was. Like, it was, and all like I don't want to I don't think that this will spoil it, but I just don't want it. Like, I don't know enough about it, but like, it had like the mental games of like Gantz. Where just like, you know, I don't know about y'all. When I first watched Gantz, like, mind you, I don't think it's aged well, right?
No.
But it's like, when I first watched it, I was like, my heart was like this. And watching this, I was like, oh my gosh. And everybody walking out of the theater was like, one girl said, like, was that one of the heavier things you've, like, she was like, is Jackie, what did you think? Did you think Goblin Slayer was heavier than this or this?
Yeah. I don't know if you all have seen the beginning of Goblin Slayer, but it is like not a
very heavy. Yeah.
Yeah. And so I was like, dang. Though I have a lot of issues with Goblin Slayer, but we won't talk
about that. Just to clarify, Jacki, would you say that like solo leveling needs a trigger warning for like that sort of thing? Or
no, it's okay. Not. So with Goblin Slayer, obviously there's like a lot of like sexual violence, obviously.
Yeah.
I want us to get banned on YouTube. There's nothing like that, but it's just like the amount of brutality in the first two episodes, like I just didn't like, I thought this was like a pretty boy.
Yeah.
Manga. Like I was like, oh my God. And then it was like, it wasn't okay. So like Kingdoms of Ruin, there's brutality out of every orifice. Why am I, Lynzee, this is your fault. Why am I using these words?
Orifice? It's
just like, yes, there's, it's just brutality word. Everywhere, but it's not good and it's not effective. Right.
Yeah. Yeah.
So, this yeah. was like, the brutality was like very, it was weighing on me like really bad. Like I felt not super attached to the characters because it's so early, but you were just kind of like, whoa, why is this all happening? You know?
Yeah.
No, that's good. Like they're, you know, if they make it effective, that's what you want, right? You know,
yeah. And I think
quality, meaningful cartoon violence is my favorite thing.
Yes. Yeah. Truth. You could not say better than that, Geoff. That
operating word is meaningful, right?
Yeah.
It's Akira being the gold standard.
Or at the very least impactful, right? Like, I don't necessarily...
I'm not expecting like
thematic brilliance from this show necessarily from what we've seen, but
it seems like the characters have some depth to them.
To be honest, I did not think that trailer did it justice.
Okay.
I really didn't like, but I think maybe they're trying to hide what happens. But I'm telling y'all, when y'all were to watch the first two episodes, like if you guys didn't like it as much as I did, I'll be surprised. Though, let's just a preface, and Lynzee and James and Geoff knows this too. I like a lot of violence and I like a lot of action, right? So it delivered in that department, and maybe it's not going to be everyone's cup of tea. Like Lynzee, like you said, like. Is there a trigger warning? Like it's. I mean, you saw all the blood. The people
dismemberment and whatnot, right? Yeah.
Like you see some pretty messed up stuff for sure. So don't watch that one with your youngest son.
Oh no.
Yeah.
No.
Unless you're a cool dad, then by all means.
No. No.
My youngest is 7.
Yeah, I was like definitely not. Yeah. Like definitely not. Yeah.
All right. Okay. Well, guys, that's. All the trailers for the winter 2024 trailer watch party. Yeah. So now it's time to put together your top fives, narrow down your list, chat. See if you can get that in there too. We'll try and share as many of those top fives as we can based on what you saw today. I'm interested to see how James's new voting method worked, assuming he didn't abandon it midstream.
Nope. I rated every single trailer.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. I mean, it's just out of 5. I didn't go like am with it. Just, you know,
we should make something I on. And in the Patreon, you get to see all of James's votes.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's like a Patreon
I could do an extra hour long breakdown of exactly why I rated every trailer.
Also, everybody, tell us what your picks are.
Tell us what your picks are. I'm going to start using my adorable Kirby Cafe pen that I got in Japan.
Are we counting Wonder Hatch?
Counting Wonder Hatch.
I know that was tough because it was still live action. I was seeing the same thing.
I don't know. Obviously they're not they're definitely not the arbiters of what is and isn't anime, but my anime list has not listed that one yet.
Well, then obviously there's no go.
And they don't have any racist reasons not to list it. So,
but I counter it with I include it. So
there we go.
That's fair.
Is in the ANN encyclopedia.
That's also true, which is valid than MAL.
And I put Scott Pilgrim on my best anime of...
It's animated by Science Saru. It's anime.
It's not a best anime.
Okay.
Maybe get that.
Now make sure you don't forget about Bucchigiri. It was a while ago, but if you recall...
I put that on my number 2.
I might need to...
I really like that one. I thought that one looked really cool.
Yeah.
No, I've got my list down already.
Oh, wow. Okay. Jeff's ahead.
Go first.
No, I'm not ready. We have to wait till everyone's ready.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, because otherwise I'll influence the rest.
I'm still whittling down over here.
I've got a feeling that all of ours are going to be the same.
Probably. Yeah.
Pretty similar. There wasn't a whole lot to pick from this season.
Yeah.
There's like, yeah, I was looking at it. There were like five shows that I think are really, no, six shows I think are really good. And then
we're only doing five, right?
I have five, and then I have three honorable mentions. But if we don't look it, I won't.
I erased one that I had. Now I gotta look it up again. Not for, just so that I have it in my list.
I want to include one of the shoujo ones I wrote down. That was me making a
horrible noise. That was you?
Yeah, I was making a horrible noise. Sorry.
I know. I was like, what is that?
Now you know what the noise I make when I can't decide what I want is. Funny. Same thing happens when I'm trying to choose a dessert. Yeah, I feel like all my picks are too similar now, and that's upsetting. Okay, I think I have them, though. Well, let me put my honorable mentions, actually. Really only got one honorable mention. Two.
I'm ready.
I honestly don't know if I can put these in, like, specifically 5 to 1.
Yeah, I can't do that either. I don't think I usually can.
I did 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, everybody.
Well, I appreciate your commitment.
I'm just bragging. Look at my little penguin pen.
Jacki, not everyone can count, all right? So it's not cool of you to flaunt that in front of, you know, those of us who have difficulty with counting.
My pen is not cute, but it is a Dr. Grip pen. These are the best, most ergonomic pens you can buy in Japan.
Is that a multicolor pen?
Yeah, it's got four colors and pencil. Four colors and pencil. And yeah, it's just really well balanced.
Did we all get our pens in Japan? I love that.
Yeah. The Japanese just make better stationery, straight up.
Better stationery
hunting for his pen.
Lynzee, do you want not?
I don't have a Japanese pen, but I wanted to hold something up to the camera. So there's
I mine. Gave James that.
Wait, yeah, talking about stationery, Lynzee, you are going to be so jealous. This is my Sailor Mercury stationery from when I was in middle school. And I wrote a love letter to my 7th grade crush on here.
Oh my god. Oh, Jack, actually, what's the first name of your 7th grade crush?
Well, it was Peter, but this is actually a letter I wrote to my best friend. So now I don't know where Peter's letter is. Sorry, Peter.
My 7th grade crush's name was Spencer. Is that on brand?
I know. Yeah. I felt like Spencer was
at least it wasn't Keith.
James, that's what I was gonna say. I was gonna be like, there could be worse names.
Could be Keith. Yeah.
I feel like Peter is a protagonist name. Wherever Peter is, hope you're doing
well. Oh, speaking of Peter and Keith, somebody mentioned this when we were talking about shit about Keith. But apparently, there's a really good joke in Family Guy about how Keith is the objectively worst name for a male.
Oh man. I'm sorry, Keith. I'm sorry.
Any Keiths watching this, we apologize for
your parents doing that to you. We do not endorse Family Guy. We're not supporting them.
No. Onikaze says, wait, wasn't Spencer the name of the off-brand Ferris Bueller series? I don't know what that is. Maybe?
Okay, Reagan has a 2000s fruits basket stationery. Like, you win. You win.
Yeah, you win that.
That is so cool. I would be.
Hell yeah, Reagan.
A&N is anti Keith. Sorry, all future freelancers. Name's Keith. Just throwing it out.
Yeah.
You get a new pen name.
Freelancers.
I mean, I guess it literally does stand for the Anti Keith News Network. So
Anti
Keith.
Yeah, it should have been self-explanatory.
Yeah. Just pick a pen name. But, you know.
One purge.
Geoff knew what his was off the bat. So why don't you lead, Geoff?
Number one, Delicious in Dungeon.
Okay.
Number two, Solo Leveling. Mm-hmm. Number three, Bucchigiri. Number four, Metallic Rouge. Number five, I don't know if Sengoku Yoko might be number one. Now that I was just reading it in the order I wrote stuff down. But Sengoku Yoko might be number one, actually. But anyway, that was not in it. Those are the five.
Okay. Man, I forgot about Metallic Rouge. I didn't write Metallic Rouge.
Me too. I just wrote it down.
So you're just changing.
I was like, shit,
just copying
we just gave
Becky copy an answer, and so you're like, oh, that's a good one.
We gave Becky kudos for commitment, and then she changes it in the final hour. Yeah. Okay,
but hold on, I had my fifth, and I was like, the fifth one's like I could have interchanged. So I was like, oh wait, no, Metallic Rouge takes fifth.
What was your fifth one that you could have interchanged?
I had the Witch and the Beast.
That's a good one. Mine was Ishida. That one looked really good. That was my sixth pick. But yeah, Witch and the Beast, you're right. That one looks really good too.
So I actually had like a few that I'm like, they weren't bad, but I'm not like chomping at the bit to watch. Like Ursa Yatsura, like I'll probably binge that like in a month when they all come out. And you know what I mean? But a great show, right? Delicious in Dungeon, I felt the same way. Like, I'm like, that's a cute, fun one that I'll probably, like, I'm not going to be waiting week to week to watch personally. For me, mine was number one Solo Leveling. I will be watching every week if they keep up what they did with episode one and two. I really liked Bucchigiri. Like, I don't know. I got, like, Tokyo Revengers, JoJo's vibes. Like, I was like, that was giving me everything. Yeah. I really want to watch season one of High Card because, like, I was like, everything I
you
saw
should there. You should it's great, lots of car chases and spy stuff, and it's real good. It's
I
really
watch that. Yeah, I put that in my third, and then fourth I put The Weakest Tamer. I forgot that one looked really solid, and then I did have The Witch and the Beast, but then I do think Metallic Rouge looked really good, so I put that at fifth. So
that's okay, James, I want to hear your top five, but I also I'm just very curious about your ranking system. So
Oh no, I literally just gave it a score out of five based on how interesting it looked.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, nothing super special. I was just keeping track of the scores because I always forget, like every time we do this, I'll be like, oh yeah, I liked that trailer, but it was from 2.5 hours ago.
Yeah.
And so
yeah,
I wanted to keep track of the stuff that I liked as we watched it. I will say, no one out of fives this year, which I think would, or this season. Honestly, almost everything was like a three.
Where I was
This looks like it could be, you know, whatever.
Yeah,
But as far as the stuff on my list, so for honorable mentions, I did end up putting Wonder Hatch there just because whether or not it's like fully an anime at this point is a little hard to say.
Yeah.
Blue Exorcist is also an honorable mention. And then my cutoff was Mr. Villain because I tend to favor action and drama over comedies for these things.
Yeah.
Point being, my in no particular order, this is like completely just what I ended up writing down, was Bucchigiri, Ishira, Metallic Rouge, Sengoku Yoko, and then Witch and the Beast. Witch and the Beast looks great.
Yeah.
Those that might be the biggest surprise for me for this watch.
Was Witch and the Beast?
That,
yeah,
for me too. Yeah, that one really caught me off guard with how good it was.
Yeah, I didn't know what the trailer was going to look like at all before going into it.
And The Weakest Tamer, that was the other one that was like a big
It had surprisingly good looking production values and stuff, you know.
Also the story looks interesting, which is I don't remember the last time I saw an anime with the weakest or something-ist RPG noun
that looked
does
good.
Something
yeah
as mm-hmm. the title that looked watchable.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah.
Like
yeah. Yeah. Thinking of the Weakest Crest show right now and how just like not
the strongest sage, the weakest crest. World's Strongest Assassin got reincarnated in another world, but when it's strongest, that's a little bit better sometimes when they just acknowledge it. But when they're like, oh, this guy's the weakest, no, he's not.
usually it's a, like a fake out.
No, there's just a loophole. He's actually the strongest.
Yeah, that's
yeah, really yeah. He's the strongest. The meta just hasn't caught up with him yet. 100% of the time, that's the plot. But that one actually looked like good.
Mm-hmm. I agree. That one was one of my honorable mentions. So my five, I feel like all of our fives are pretty close with like just maybe one difference in here. So I have Bucchigiri for sure. Witch and Beast, which I guess you can say that one kind of pushed out Metallic Rouge a little bit. I'm spoiled because I got to see the first episode, I guess. So I kind of Solo Leveling for sure. Sengoku Yoko and Delicious in Dungeon are my five. Honorable mentions, Sign of Affection, and Mr. Villain's Day Off. So that was hard because I wanted to give I wanted to spotlight those, you know, because like that genre is ignored a lot compared to the more action heavy stuff. But
comedy definitely is ignored, but it's like comedy has to be so good.
It does.
No, it has to really. Yeah.
It's gotta grab you. And it's hard for a comedy to sell itself with the trailer. Like, unless it's something with really crazy, amazing visuals, like 100 Girlfriends, where like you immediately get what's funny about it.
Yeah, Asobase. Yeah, that one was really good too.
Yeah.
Really
God, Asobi Asobase.
That is probably to date the funniest anime comedy I've ever seen. Just
like, it's up there, but I'd still put Haven't You Heard I'm Sakamoto-kun above it.
Or Monthly Girls in Osaka. Have you guys seen Cromartie High School?
No.
Years ago.
I know what it looks like, but I haven't.
So it's kind of like the reason I brought it up in Bucchigiri is the premise is it's about like a school full of delinquents and one normal guy who ends up going there in order to prove to his friend who thought he was doomed to never get into a good school that a good student can learn anywhere. And then his friend was too stupid to get into that school, so he's alone, surrounded by thugs, including but not limited to big scary guys with mohawks, a actual literal 400-pound gorilla. Just,
oh my
it's
God.
A gorilla that is in the school. It's just there. There's also a robot named Mechazawa. Everybody knows the gorilla's a gorilla. Nobody knows Mechazawa's a robot. Everybody thinks Mechazawa's just a really nice guy. And Freddie Mercury. Mercury also goes to
Yes, school. I remember.
Yeah. What is this one called, Jeff?
Cromartie High School. It's one of the greatest comedy anime ever made. Fair warning, the dub has some slurs in it because it was early 2000s dub. But yeah. Other than that, aged impeccably.
So all I know about
Cromartie... Now they age better than the Ghost Hunters or the Ghost Stories dub, right?
Yeah.
So for Cromartie High School, this is going to be so random. All I know about this anime is that the guy eats a bunch of pencils.
Yeah, that's the first episode. That's the first...
I was like, what the hell? And then also, I wish I could share this with you, Lynzee. There is this scene where they're walking down the hallway, and I don't give a... It is one of the baddest ass scenes I've ever seen. They're walking down this hallway. Do you know what I'm talking about, Jeff?
Yes, yeah. That might be from the opening.
And they just look so hard. Like,
And there's like moai heads and UFOs bouncing off of them because so the guy, he's staring down this guy at his desk, right? And he's like, man, that guy's scary. And he like puts down a pen, he drops his pencil, the guy just picks it up and eats it. And then he like looks at him for a second, he's like, drops all of the pencils in his case on his desk just to see what'll happen. And the guy just looks at them, looks at him, picks all of them up.
Yeah.
It's so weird.
That's wild.
Go to the link I just sent you and go to 43 seconds in and just tell me that's not the most baddest ass walk
you've ever seen. If we're going to do it, I'm going to show it to everyone.
Good idea. Just play the opening. The opening is beautiful.
We will end on this and then I'm going to tell everyone I love you, good night, because
farewell.
Go to 43 seconds. Yeah.
We'll watch the whole thing. It's fine. It's only a minute.
Okay.
Oh, every episode also starts with him saying, don't imitate what happens in the show.
Yeah, apparently this is on Retro Crush, guys, if you want to go watch it.
Guys, don't sleep on Retro Crush. Retro Crush.
I'm going to up the volume a little bit.
This is really hitting me in the middle school right now.
I'm gonna watch this.
You should.
I really am. You bringing it up reminded me of it. All right, it's gonna hit you, everybody. Brace yourselves. Brace yourselves. This is the hardest walk I've ever seen. Do not mess with these guys. This is the hardest walk I've ever. Am I wrong? Is
that no. Just there's Freddy.
There's
Freddy.
There's Freddy M.
He rides a horse.
Yeah, he has a horse. He rides it to school sometimes.
Oh my god! I'm sorry.
That guy's the toughest guy in school. 40th
anniversary anime for TV Tokyo. I gotta talk
to
you.
By the way, everyone, this anime is 20 years old if you want to feel older.
There's so many great things about this. They were not allowed to animate any of the kids smoking. So instead they've all just got these sticks with like little CGI slimes on them that bounce up and down whenever they talk. There's also a really good movie, a legitimately great movie based on the series. It's greatest
like
anime
a live action film.
What? Yeah, live action. Goes through a lot of the same beats, but takes it in a different direction. So if you enjoy that, I would also recommend seeking that out. But yeah.
I'll put that on for New Year's. I like to watch old things on New Year's Eve. Like, I think last year I watched Twilight Zone, but maybe I'll put on Cromartie High School this time.
I literally just pulled it up. Like, I'm going to watch it.
Yeah.
Lynzee, is that opening scene not one of the... They look so good. I don't know what it is. It's like the way they're
They just got swag.
They don't even care.
They don't get
it. A little bit.
It's amazing. Anyway, sorry. Lindsay's like, please, let me spend time with my family.
I'm sure my family's like behind the door. Like,
Would you recommend this if I liked Under Ninja? Yeah. 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 Yes.
Yes. All right, everybody. That wraps up another version. Iteration. That's the word that I want. That wraps up another iteration of the trailer watch party. If you enjoyed yourself, you know, this should still be on YouTube afterwards. We didn't get kicked once this time.
Because they've learned to respect the game.
They did. Yeah. So go ahead and you share this with your friends, send it to them if they're still trying to decide what to watch. Anime News Network's preview guide, where we review the first episode of every single show airing the season. James is a part of it. Starts on January 3rd.
God help us all.
God help us all, which is what we say every 3 months when we do this. So make sure to head over to Anime News Network on January 3rd so you can, you know, get all the reviews from our team. They'll be staying up. I hope you guys don't actually stay up late. I was going to say staying up late, and then I'm like, I don't do that. I don't make you guys do that. But anyway, you can find out their takes on every single show as it premieres. That might help you if this trailer watch party didn't already, you know, like firm up your, I got to stop.
Yeah, just...
Yeah, you just... You're... Like, what happened?
I don't know.
Do we need to start...
Solidify? It didn't help you. You didn't solidify your watch list. January 3rd. And we'll be updating it. Until all the shows are done. I'm apparently broken and full of horny or something.
We gotta get a soundboard and just have, like, the phrasing joke from Archer on there.
Yeah. Yeah.
Lindsay rubbed off on me. I started saying orifice. I was like, when the hell have I said orifice out loud? Of course.
Well, you said they're bleeding out of every orifice. Like, how else do you denote that there's blood coming out of every hole in their body without using orifice?
We got to cut the show, everybody. We got to go. We're off the rails too much.
If you support my vocabulary, give me a thumbs up in the chat. Bye, everyone, and see you next time.
Bye.